All right, man, we are here live. It's your boy, Brad the Bard, with Eric Naples. We're over here drinking some beers at Art of War. Let me actually fade that out because we don't have a guest right now, but we're going to have some post-fight interviews and stuff with the fighters. We're kind of doing like a fight companion thing. Eric, you looking forward to anything specific tonight? We got a big heavyweight fight coming up, man.
Yeah, we got that heavyweight title fight. We were able to talk to the champ a little bit backstage. But, you know, if there's not going to be, when there's not fighters that'll be sitting next to me, we're going to try to get some other teammates and coaches, too. I remember we were talking to that one dude. He said he gave us the laundry list of injuries he had.
Yeah,
that dude sounded like a trip, man.
Yeah,
I want to talk to him.
There's a lot of really awesome guys in the fight, the warm-up area from the teams and everything. So we're going to have a bunch of guest guys over here. We got another mic over there. But as for right now, we're going to pop some brewskis. So if you're at home and you want to drink with us, we're going to play a drinking game where we got to slam these every time someone gets tapped with a heel hook.
I thought you were going to say take a sip every time somebody gets punched in their face.
Punched in the face.
How do you use a butterfly knife?
I'll show you. So there's a trick to it, right? We get that thumb knuckle,
okay,
and we use that as a hinge, right? So we got to get that metal in there first.
Nice.
And then we get in place with the knuckle.
Oh, wow. Just took my eye out.
That's how it do.
It's caveman shit.
Cheers, Mr. Naples.
Sir.
Maple syrup in the house.
All right, so besides the fights that we got going on in front of us tonight, there's also a UFC fight night going on. So I have that on my phone. I'll be talking about that as well.
Yeah, I see it right there. We're going to be doing all kinds of fight commentary today. And make sure you guys can comment, do some Q&A. We can hang out and all that good shit, man. It's going to be a good night. So, Eric, you actually competed at Art of War for your first MMA debut.
Yeah.
Lost by decision,
mm-hmm,
and that was honestly like an awesome fucking fight, right? Like,
yeah, man,
I thought it was like, in your experience, like, do you think that was a great time? Like, do you want to keep it up with the MMA shit, man?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I fought a pretty good dude who from a team who has a couple of guys fighting here tonight.
Yeah,
you know, it was great. I wouldn't have picked any other promotion besides Art of War. Like, the whole thing was a great experience from start to finish.
Yeah.
It was everything I hoped it would be and more. So
yeah.
And honestly, it's just, you know, how I look at it, maybe MMA isn't my main focus, but it definitely made me, just that one fight made me a better jiu-jitsu competitor.
You think so?
Yeah.
Well, it's
sure.
Interesting. We were kind of talking earlier, the guy that they put you up against, right? He had won quite a few bouts, right? And he is like a really talented striker. Probably one of the top strikers on the card.
For sure.
You come in as one of the top grapplers on the card. So it was really cool to see like the dynamic change there. And unfortunately, like we were talking about this as well, the rule set prohibited you from heel hooking him, but you had him in the backside 50-50.
I could have submitted
him right there, but the ref was getting butthurt about it.
Maybe, yeah. You never know. There are some states that are pretty liberal with the rules. Like, you can heel hook, you can head kick. Pennsylvania, you know, you can't do any kind of twisting leg locks. You can't ground and pound to the head. Not only that, but it's short rounds. So if you're a grappler, you have to get it going pretty fast.
Yeah.
It favors the guy who would rather be, up on their feet.
Yeah.
Unluckily for me, the dude had good takedown defense. His wrestling was sick. He was a really good wrestler. So,
That's just good, one
of those things.
You definitely got thrown like right into the mix against a super well-armed opponent, you know, right out the gate.
It
took some balls to even say yes to that.
Yeah, people who know, like, the Philly MMA scene, I would tell them, they'd be like, oh, you're fighting. I'm like, yeah. And they're like, who are you going against? And I would tell them, and they would be like, you're fighting that kid for your first one? I was like, yeah, what's the issue? Just a jiu-jitsu guy, dude. I don't know what I was getting myself into.
Yeah. I think you're definitely harder than most out there in the jiu-jitsu scene as an individual that would take the challenge up there.
Awesome. Here we go with the introductions.
Oh, man, they're getting everybody hyped.
Yeah, it's going to get rowdy in here towards the end of the card. Let's see who we got here. Let me look at this list.
Oh, shit, here we go. We got Sharko. Lito and I are watching live right now, taking fat dabs. This is the best podcast. Thanks,
nice,
man. That's got to be Matt Devorey and the guys over there.
Nice.
From Ambush. It's It's going to be pretty lit, man. I'm excited, dude. You know, like, the World Series is coming up, too. Like, the Phillies are playing and all that stuff.
Phillies are up one.
Yeah. You like to watch other sports, too, besides MMA?
You know, I could get into a little bit of basketball. I never really watched football or baseball too much.
Yeah. Dude, I'll be honest, man. I only like fights.
That's how I am, man.
Unless I'm playing a sport, like, even like, some fights, like, I'll watch, like boxing. I like, actually, all martial arts I love to watch, I'll be honest.
Yo, have you seen Karate Combat?
Karate Combat? Yeah. Tell me about it. I have no idea what it is. It's like striking, kickboxing kind of thing?
It's basically, it's like MMA striking, right? But the cage, it's not even a cage. What they fight in is so weird. It's like a trapezoid, and the walls are slanted. The walls are on like a 45.
What are they, chain link fence?
No, it's like mats. It's like a mats on a 45, and it makes like the clinch work so weird and unique. Like, I mean, imagine two dudes like clinching like getting wailed on. It's insane.
It's like a bunch of Beyblades spinning around.
So yeah,
around
if somebody gets, you know, how somebody like if they get dropped in a fight, sometimes the wall can kind of save them. They'll bounce off the wall.
Yeah, yeah.
This is like, it takes it a step further because they don't just bounce off the wall. They're laying down on a 45 now, just getting teed off on. I've seen people have done crazy stuff.
No, we're good. Thanks.
People have done crazy stuff, like against the back of that wall. Like, you remember Anthony Pettis' Showtime kick and how people were doing Superman punches off the cage?
Yeah.
They get very inventive with stuff like that off the wall. Like, follow their page and then go and watch some of their highlights. It's crazy.
Damn, dude.
They got some sick knockouts, too.
Yeah. You'll have to send me some of that stuff on the gram later.
I'm
interested, for sure. Yeah, man, it's pretty packed in here today, man. It's a good day. We're gonna have a fucking ball in time today, boys.
Yeah, man. I mean, the last event was definitely a little bit bigger than this as far as the numbers and the crowd.
Yeah, yeah.
Because everyone was like super local.
Hey, we're live from Lebanon, Pennsylvania here today too. Definitely want to mention that. Art of War seems to do a lot of their stuff in Pennsylvania. Are you aware of them doing anything outside of PA? I'm not.
I'm not so sure. I know that they are all up and down PA.
Yeah.
Jersey. I know that they have some stuff in Jersey, too, like Atlantic City.
Nice, nice. It's good stuff, man. All right, man. I think they're doing, like, some kind of hype kind of stuff that they're trying to drum together here.
Yeah, well, it looks like our first fight is going to be a 125-pound match between Joseph Galen and Malik Gons. So yeah, both guys, I did a little bit of research. It looks like both guys are 0-0, both making their debuts.
Oh, they're both making their debuts for this first match?
Yeah.
That's good stuff. Yeah, so Ben Moser, we actually, I believe, met him in the back. He has quite a few guys from his team. I hope we get to talk to him later.
Yeah, that's our main event, Ben Moser, right?
Yeah. Yeah, he said... He said he had trained at with Andrew before. Maybe he had a match
before from
Valley. So shout out to the Valley guys. We got some lore going on with the people we've teed off against and stuff in the past. It's always good to see people you've encountered before kind of work too. You get to like watch their evolution.
Sure.
Are there any MMA fighters like in the local scene that you tend to follow a lot? Like, you know, UFC fighters,
like
or
local
or
dudes?
Otherwise, yeah.
Maybe not UFC fighters.
I think both of us are obviously like big fans of the grapplers in the area.
Yeah,
I think that's
for
where
sure.
We both have our, you know, our strong suit. But
you know, there's a couple of dudes that I guess are in the UFC now that I've known about for a long time. Just like cross training when I was a blue belt and stuff.
Yeah.
Most of them are at Marquez MMA right now.
Yeah.
But you know, there's some up and comers like guys that I've had matches with that are like still doing pretty well, amateur and pro. I've had a lot of grappling matches with pro fighters.
Yeah.
And I do like to watch how their career progresses and just see them grow. It's very cool.
Yeah. No, that's awesome, man. I really appreciate getting to kind of have the opportunity to even sit and talk with a lot of these guys because I was over at Finishers the other day for your event.
Yeah.
Like last weekend. And, It was funny because you had half the people in the room watching the jiu-jitsu fights, but then like
there's a pay-per-view right there
with the UFC on the TV, so it was like half the room, like Dude, was interesting.
I wanted to watch that card so bad, but I kind of just made myself forget about it because I had that match. And
It was good stuff. I got to watch the Peter Yan fight.
What did you think of it?
Dude, I mean, when I watch MMA, dude, unless I'm watching street beefs, I'm like, fuck, dude, I never want to encounter these people ever. I watch street beefs, and I'm like, I want to do MMA.
And then I watch pro fighting. And then it's like, holy shit, this is different.
There's no way I could ever do that. You have to devote so much to it, man. It's that.
Like, dude, I remember when I was getting ready for my fight, I would go and spar with some smaller like pros, just
Where
from
at?
In the area. I went to Marquez a couple of times just for some sparring with some of the lighter weight dudes. I'm friends with a couple of the flyweights there, and sometimes they'd come to my gym and we'd get some work in. Typically just stick with the smaller dudes, but there was one, I'm not going to say any names, but there was a small dude who's not really like a big striker.
Yeah.
But he's a pro. And he fucking beat me up really bad on the feet and made me feel really bad about myself.
Yeah.
I was like, holy shit, dude.
Yeah, that's funny as hell. So I know you're training with Danny for like your striking stuff, and I've taken some of Danny's boxing class, Danny Murray over there at the Hive.
It's funny you mentioned him. I saw him teaching his class last night. I was cracking up, dude.
He's so funny.
Dude, his coaching is insane. It, like in a good way, like insanely high level. But then again, like the shit he says is just so off the wall. It's crazy.
Yeah, it was funny as hell. Like, cause I was trash at boxing. Like, I actually did boxing before I did jiu-jitsu.
Really?
And then I kind of benched it forever. So then I took a couple, like back in Studio 84 days, I had taken a couple of his classes just to kind of sit in and kind of see where I was at. And bro, he would like smack me upside the head with the pool noodle. Like, come on, bro. Like, get your fucking act together. Because I was just so uncoordinated.
He was going in on this kid last
night. Yeah, that's so fucking funny. He's such a good dude, though. Like, he as long as you're good at taking criticism, having a coach like that can be so beneficial, man.
Yeah. He's not good. I mean, because he's not fucking telling you. He's like you're going to get punched in your fucking face. He's not telling that because, like, he doesn't like you. He's telling you because he doesn't want you to get punched in the face.
Yeah, man. It's like, fix this, dude. Like, get your act together.
Yeah.
It's so good. Like, I think, honestly, like, I haven't had many boxing coaches in my day.
Right.
Aside from one of the, you know, when I first started doing it back in the day. But if I was going to do an MMA fight, I think I would approach Danny to help me out.
Yeah. I mean,
I trust him, too. You know what I mean? You gotta approach someone you trust as a coach.
For sure. I mean, I didn't take a fight for so long. One, because maybe I wasn't ready, and two, because I didn't really have a coach that I could really trust as far as like boxing, you know, or striking in general. But you know, Danny told me, you know, straight up where he thought I was, and what type of fights I should be taking. You know, I trust him because he's super high level.
Yeah.
You know. I mean, look at the fighters he's trained with and trained before. They're doing really well.
Yeah, no doubt. Yeah, Jalen, right? He's got a good record right now. I remember the last time I was in the gym. He was practicing, I think, and, you know, correct me if I'm wrong if you're watching this, Jalen, but he was working on the spinning back like fist thing or like an elbow or something. He was doing something. He's like, man, I want to knock someone the fuck out of this. Like, I was like, yeah, you're fucking good.
Yeah, every now and then.
Like the wheel kick or something. It was something where he turns his back.
Oh, it was probably a wheel kick.
Yeah, he was the wheel kicks his thing.
Yeah, every now and then Jalen will get this idea in his head and he'll be like, super focused on it. He'll be working on it really hard.
Yeah.
I'm going to fucking hit this.
Yeah. I'll bet you he'll get it, man.
He helped me a lot, man. Yeah. He helped me a lot for my fight.
You trained with him a lot? Like, you sparred with him a lot?
Yeah. Him and Mike were my main dudes for getting me ready for that fight.
Him and Mike?
McCaffrey.
Yo, yeah.
You remember him?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, I was just talking to him.
He's like a wrestler guy, right?
Uh-huh.
Yep. Yeah, dude. I remember rolling with him in the Studio 84 days. Dude fucking trashed me, yeah. Very, very, very strong on the feet.
Yeah,
very
for sure.
Very strong on the feet. There's another guy from Studio that just fought I don't even remember, CFFC? I can't remember his name right now.
What's he look like?
Fuck, I'm getting fucking distracted by the man over here.
DJ, photographer, jack of all trades.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Yeah, man, drop me a card and
what
stuff.
What is it? Let me see that right now.
Yeah, yeah.
Got you.
It's going to be a good night, man. Yeah, DJ over here. Make sure you guys check him out. What did he say is a thing? Supreme Sound Productions?
As soon as I get it, I will.
Really good Supreme. Dude. We gave him a beer, and he's been treating us good all night. Let me get back to this fucking... I'm blanking on his
Here
name right now.
Supreme Sound Productions on IG.
Get him, yeah.
Hit him with the follow.
Riley. Riley's his name.
Oh, Palmer.
Yeah, dude. He's a beast.
Yeah.
He fucking trashed the dude. I just watched his fight. He was incredible.
We watched that at the Hive.
Yeah. You guys were watching.
Yeah. Yeah.
Dude,
he beat that dude up.
I saw it live, dude. Mm-hmm.
You were there?
Yeah, dude. It was such a good fight, man. I went to go watch Alex Myers from Saga. I don't know if you know too much about the Saga guys.
He has a brother, right? Kyle and Alex.
Kyle fought at Finishers with you just recently. It's funny, actually. I told Alex, I was like, hey man, if you want me to help you for your fight, like, you know, I'm a purple belt, he's a black belt heavyweight.
Yeah.
That does MMA, but I'm like, yo, I'll do like a combat jiu-jitsu round with you if you want before your fight. And then my car took a shit, so I never got over there. But I told him, like, yo, I'll still do it. Like at the event, I'm like, dude, I'll still train with you with some combat jiu-jitsu. So the other night, he came over and like, all right, I came over to Saga, and he gave me the fucking grease. What's going on, Mike? We're live on YouTube right now.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, that would be great. We would love that. Yeah, dude, just filter them over here, and we'll be glad to take care of them. Like, yeah. Yeah. No, yeah, man, we'll take care of them, man. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, definitely. We'll be taking notes all night. Thank you very much, Mike. Yeah, man, we got stickers over here, too, if you want to hand some out or even keep some for yourself. Thank you very much, Mike. Yeah, Mike was just mentioning to us we're going to be doing some knockout of the night and stuff like that. He had a couple things, like fight of the night, maybe quickest knockout or something like that. So we're going to have some really cool stuff coming up here, man. It's gonna be a really great night.
Yeah, Mike's a good dude, man.
Yeah.
He really does this right.
He just came up to us, and I don't know if you guys could hear that very well, but he's basically telling us to really just take care of these newer guys. You know, we got a couple debut fighters, like Eric mentioned, and, you know, I think it's so important to do that, man. Like, you got to really give people a platform. That's the whole thing with my podcast, man. Like, the reason I was going out of my way with the bus thing, I'm like, yo, I got to go to these gyms and, like, find all my people that I look up to, because that's what it is, man. Like, you got to be a hard motherfucker to step in a ring. So
yeah, it's different for sure. So dudes need respect
all day.
They're definitely working hard.
Yeah, no doubt, man. So tell me a little bit about like your training regimen leading up to like doing your fight, because like I was saying, like I did that combat jiu-jitsu with Alex. He just fucking trashed me. It was so funny though. It's like, dude, 100 pounds and the skill gap, that'll do something. good, thanks.
Thank you.
Yeah, it was just so fun. So, like, how do you go about doing, like, your ramp up?
She's asking us if we, like, as far as what? What was she asking us just there?
She's asking if we have any trash to take.
The fuck?
What?
Talking about who? Who's trash?
No, she said, do you have any trash for us to take?
Oh, I thought she was calling one of us trash.
Nah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, dude.
Okay.
You gonna go knock her out? Tell her to spin the block.
No, I don't. I don't do no knocking out, man.
No. Not at all. Damn, I don't know what to tell you, bro.
What happened?
Something.
What's wrong?
Yeah, something's going on. Someone maybe stepped on a cable
or
something.
Is that like for the stream, for the fights? Oh, well, that's why.
Yeah, not us, dude.
Well, that's why the fights haven't started yet. It's looked like they're having some technical difficulties on the streaming end, but it's like we're doing pretty good, huh?
We're doing money, man.
We could do this all night. Probably be maybe 10, 11 o'clock before they get the first fight figured out. Nah, they should be up and running shortly.
Yeah, no, definitely. They're kind of doing some logistical stuff. I just wanted to start the stream early when my man's here. But yeah, Eric, tell me a little bit about what do you do, like, where you're sparring and stuff, man? Like, how do you ramp up for an MMA fight? Like, I think, in my personal opinion, I love to do, like, striking rounds in the gym, like in Valley, like with some of the more advanced guys. Like, I don't do that with any white belts or anything like that. Only guys that know how their body works, you know what I mean? We'll strike around, like, 30%, and we'll ramp it up if you're not moving.
Right.
But, like, you know, we're grappling at, like, 90, you know what I mean?
Yeah, so I was grappling every day, whether I was doing just regular jiu-jitsu, wall work, wrestling, stuff like that. I was grappling every single day, but striking, I was probably training striking 2 to 3 times a week.
Okay. Do you feel like that's adequate? Like, you know your regimen, right? Like, you know your body better than anybody.
No, you have to be doing that shit every single day.
Yeah.
If you're serious about it and you want to get good fast, you have to do it every day. Like, the same way that I do jiu-jitsu, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm always thinking about jiu-jitsu and grappling. You have to do the same for... And it's not just striking. It's MMA. You have to do everything every single day.
Yeah.
That's what I've found out just by watching the guys that I've trained with, that I look up to, who are really good. That's what they do. So, but what I was doing, I was probably striking about 2 to 3 times a week. And, dude, I only really... Formal training, I only really had about 6 months. Yeah, 6 months of training, 2 to 3 times a week striking. Was it enough? Maybe, maybe not. To take on a really good striker? No, definitely not. But, you know, I wouldn't have taken the fight if I didn't think I could win with my wrestling and my grappling.
Yeah.
So, but as far as, like, the actual training, working with Danny, just doing the regular classes with him.
Would you do just strictly boxing rounds at all?
No.
No?
No.
Why not?
Because I had a fight scheduled.
I'm wondering, like, you might think, and you know, I'm kind of curious on your perspective, but I would think, like, maybe you have to come at it from the perspective of, like, you're 100% confident in your grappling, right?
Right.
You're a world champion, you know what I mean, as far as I'm concerned. Like,
right.
You've beaten world champions and everything like that. So you might want to focus on, like, specifically targeting, like, the weakness part. But I think, like, now that I'm even saying this, like, you're kind of right from the perspective of, like, it's MMA, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's not just a boxing match.
Yeah, because certain things that you would do at a high level boxing, they just will not fly in even low level MMA.
Yeah.
And the same goes for the opposite. So, we were doing, you know, strictly striking rounds, of course, kicks and punches, and striking mixed in with grappling, but never strictly boxing.
Yeah.
Except for, like, when I would do like Danny's weekday classes, just to get in there, get moving, then. We weren't even sparring then. My sparring would be either in Delaware or on the weekends at the
Hive. You spar with your brother a lot?
Not really. Maybe a couple rounds here and there.
Who at Elite would you spar with? Like,
yo,
MMA stuff?
There was this chick. her name's Shannon Shade. She was a fighter back in like maybe like 2012 or something like that. She has like a 4-second knockout in one of her fights. She's tough, man.
Was it like a fucking flying knee or something?
What was it? It was like a lead head kick and then a straight, and it put the girl out.
Damn.
Yeah, so she's legit.
Turned someone's brain off.
I was sparring with her. We had some good rounds. I got some clips of our rounds. She was a big help.
Yeah.
But really, Jalen really helped me a lot, and Mike too. McCaffrey, the kid we were just talking about.
I'd love to, like, do some sparring rounds with you guys. Like, I know I'll get pieced up, but I love to know that about myself. You know, like, I had to remind myself when I got my purple belt, because I remember, like, I never won a blue belt tournament before I got my purple belt, and I'm like, fuck, dude, this doesn't feel right. But then I had to remind myself, like, why do I do jiu-jitsu? Because it's not to compete.
Right.
And I never did it to compete. I just compete because it's fun to compete. I don't want to be like a champion or anything like that. My goal was, can I win a street fight against 90% of the population?
That's a unique goal. Everybody's got goals.
Yep. So to me, like, that's why I've been integrating, like, a lot of the striking lately, and that's why I've been, like, really into more MMA lately than I've been into jiu-jitsu, honestly. I've been watching, like, every UFC and shit.
Yeah.
And I remember the time we did the UFC fights at your brother's house, actually, in the basement. That was a fun time.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, was that the same day that you guys did the podcast? Or was that, like...
Yeah, I think that was the same...
Because you guys went climbing, right?
Yes. Yep.
And it was that same day?
I don't think it was the same day, actually. Come to think of it, we filmed that, but we didn't do the podcast till later.
Oh,
I mean, earlier, I guess. Or my timeline's actually kind of fucked up on that, come to think of it.
I don't remember which card... Wait, I fell asleep, remember?
Yeah, I do remember.
Yeah.
I remember...
I reffed a good fight that day. I reffed a good fight that day. The fights were on while I was reffing because it was early. It was during COVID.
You came late, I remember.
And then we went over to my brother's house, and I was exhausted, and I fell asleep during the main event, I think.
You fell asleep for some of the main fights, for sure. Shame on you.
Yeah. I remember watching... I want to say Robert Whittaker fought on that card, too. He beat somebody's ass.
Yeah, dude, Whitaker's a monster. Isn't Whitaker doing something aside from UFC now? He does like 1FC or something. Someone told me that. I feel like that's a thing.
No, Whitaker's still in the UFC. Yeah.
Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm wrong.
A lot of dudes getting cut from the UFC.
What's that?
Like, a lot of dudes are like not renewing their UFC contracts recently.
Yeah, because you're stuck with it, right? If you do one promotion, you usually have to stay with that one throughout the contract and not do any other fights.
Like, I saw Bobby Green just got released. You ever watch Bobby Green fight?
Yeah, dude, I think...
Dude's entertaining.
I might have seen him when I saw you... I don't remember which UFC it was. It was in Houston. Tuivasa fought Derek Lewis. He was on that, right?
I'm pretty
Bobby
sure,
Green
yeah.
was on that, yeah. I saw him. That was the first UFC I ever saw in person with Tom Selimer and the Jewish better. It was a great fucking fight, dude. Every one of those fights was amazing, dude.
Dude, I've never been to a live UFC event.
You gotta do it, dude. It's unique.
They have been like newer.
Dude,
sometimes.
Fucking Selimer did like 3 shoeys.
No, really?
Yeah.
What an animal.
Yo, Tom's a fucking monster, dude.
I miss him, dude. I haven't seen him in a while.
Yeah, man, he's in Europe right now. Tom Selimer, where are you?
Yeah, he's everywhere.
I fucking love Tom, dude. Tom's a fucking goon, man. We went to like the club and shit. He's such a man.
Yeah.
He's such a dude. All right, man. I'm ready for these fights. What's good with it, man? I'm about to get through.
I mean, let's say they don't get the.
I feel like they're having some issues over there. What's going on with it?
Oh man, if we see a fight in the crowd, we're definitely flipping the camera so you guys can see that too. I don't know. I was going to say, however long these technical issues go on for, they're going to have to, like, you know, make these guys fight at some point, whether there's
real,
a stream
man.
Going or not.
Get with the program. All right, man. But yeah, what else you got coming up, man? Tell me about the Eric business.
Oh, you know, I got a match on November 13th. I guess that's
who you fight
7 days from now. It's going against a kid named Bryce Lane. He's a MMA dude from New York.
But you're doing a grappling match
against him. Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, nothing in the foreseeable future for MMA.
Yeah.
People are like, when you fight next? I'm like, I haven't thought about it, you know?
Yeah. Would you take like a... I know you enough to know that like you would take a jiu-jitsu match like at the drop of a hat for the most part.
Yeah, pretty much.
Against most people. But like with MMA, do you feel like you're the same way? Or you kind of like, you better give me at least some.
If I'm not actively
to camp out for that.
If I'm training, then yeah, because that's the same reason I would take a jiu-jitsu match in a heartbeat. But if I'm not training for something, that's just irresponsible to take it right away. It's there are guys that do that, believe it or not.
Yeah, I believe it, dude.
I don't know if it's because their coach doesn't care about what they do, or maybe they don't care about themselves and their own health, but. I'm not doing that.
That's funny, man.
Even if the dude's like 0-4, and I know I could beat his ass really easy.
Yeah, you still want to camp. Some camp
like,
time.
I don't care. I don't care if it's like the easiest match in the world. I'm not taking it if I'm not training for it.
Yeah. 100%.
It's not fair to either party, you know?
It's not fair to what?
To either party. You got to be professional about it in one way or another.
Man. I feel like there's a serious distinction between, like, an MMA fight and a grappling match.
Yeah, man. For sure.
So, like, you have a unique perspective as well from coming from both of those backgrounds, right?
Yeah.
What do you think, like, as an amateur, like, it's so hard to, like, what's a pro jiu-jitsu fighter, right? Like, if you've gone to, like, if you've been to ADCC, I guess you could consider that a pro, but, like, couldn't you consider like an IBJJF or Pan American kind of thing as a professional competition?
So it's hard. The line isn't really drawn. The line is kind of placed per event.
Yeah.
So like let's say that I get my black belt and I. Let's wait for these introductions to get through and.
All right, we're getting it on.
Folks, as you can tell, everybody's got seat assignments. Make sure you got the right one. We got a lot going on the outside. Our merchandise tables are out there. Refreshment stands. Most guys have a good time here tonight. We want everybody to enjoy the event. as we present to you Art of War 26. We've got a big card in store for all of you. It's going to start hot. It's going to start at 7 o'clock. Barring any other
7 o'clock.
10 minutes.
All right, 10 minutes from now.
So make sure you guys get settled so we can kick it off at 7 p.m. sharp with tonight's Art of War 26 event. With that, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back in just 10 short minutes.
10 short minutes. You heard it.
Yeah, what I was saying, let's say I get a black belt and I win IBJJF Worlds. That doesn't make me a professional jiu-jitsu athlete, because at the end of the day, jiu-jitsu is an amateur sport. You know, there's no organization. Now, I will say that
no organization, but what about like IBJJF? You wouldn't consider
that's
that?
Not professional jiu-jitsu, because they don't pay until black belt tournaments. Only certain black belt tournaments they pay. So I still consider it an amateur sport.
If you get paid to do it?
By textbook definition. Now, I will say this. If you win a world championship at the brown or black belt level, then yeah, that would be professional level jiu-jitsu. Because those are the dudes that are going to 1FC and who's number one and making it in the big bucks.
Yeah.
I'm not going to say an actual number, because the pay scale, I think it's it varies a lot. You know, in between.
Did you get paid well, like when you did the MMA stuff, like maybe like on a scale like versus like the jiu-jitsu stuff? Do you feel like how do you feel about that whole thing, the dynamic, you know?
I mean, I did an amateur fight, so you know, I didn't get paid. I mean, I'll tell you that it's a lot easier to sell tickets to your friends and family when they know that you're going to be in there, you know, banging it out. They don't want to see grappling. They want to see you fight. So, like, I got ticket commission, right?
Yeah.
But that was, like, my friends and family's money. That wasn't somebody else. That wasn't the promoter or another party paying me.
Yeah. Okay, fair enough.
Now, the money that I've made in jiu-jitsu is off of matches is very little. Like, certain super fights, I'll get like 150 or $200 for a win, which is nothing. That just pays for my gas there and back. It's nothing to write home about. In jiu-jitsu, you don't start seeing the money until those really big events that are like streamed on Flow Grappling, like I said, Who's Number One, or even, you know, 1FC. They got that deal with Amazon now. I'll tell
pay. Fight to win pays you, yeah.
Not much.
Not much.
Know? I mean, they pay, which is great, especially if you're like a purple belt.
You know? Like I've heard that. Yeah, like everyone that I've heard like says like, most of the purple belts, right? Like it's like their first time getting paid to grapple,
It's pretty hype.
It's cool, you know. I fuck with that.
When they
any promotion
Philly,
that takes care of the performers, dude. Like,
yeah, when they were important. In Philly, I remember if you were a purple belt and you submitted somebody, you get like $300.
You get like a bonus for a sub.
Yeah, it was like you'll get $300 for a submission and $150 for a decision win. That's if the ticket sales hit a certain mark.
Yeah.
So that was like the pay was doubled. And when the pay was doubled, which it always was in Philly, because that venue always sold out.
Yeah.
That means the black belts would get like $500 for a submission, which could you imagine being a black belt facing a scrub and like, you know, you're going to sub the dude and you get $500 easy. Like that's such an easy night.
That's funny, man. But I don't know, man. I'd love to do a super fight. I think
one already?
Yeah, I actually have when I was a blue belt. It was a small promotion, but I'd love to do like even finishers. Like I have so much respect for finishers. Like I love Zach and all the guys over there for one. So
yeah,
I'm biased already with that, but
the finishers
just,
probably my favorite
such a promotion, great
promotion to compete for.
Man. Like it's just like it's jiu-jitsu by jiu-jitsu for jiu-jitsu.
Yeah.
Like, it's
the
it's
fact
it.
That they got that Flow Grappling deal, that's huge. That's awesome.
I'm mad proud of them, man. I'm so glad that they got that working out, man.
I
couldn't be happier for them.
For a while, like, from what I understand, Flow was trying to get a deal with them for a very long time, and it wasn't until recently that they actually finalized it.
Yeah.
Smart
on the behalf of Flow, dude.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Look who's involved at finishers, dude. You got Thor was sitting there, man. You got fucking Big J.
Yeah.
And like, Jess, obviously, doing, like, the commentary. It's like, this is Emerald City status, like, you know, as far as like the quality of the fights.
Yeah, definitely.
You know what I mean?
And Zach was saying on an Instagram video a little bit ago that all their champions are either ranked in Flow or they're world class. They have world titles and stuff. You know, their champions are very like well respected.
Yeah.
To name a few, you know, you got Andrew Tackett, Alex DeWen, who just won Pans at black belt. Trinity Pun's super good. She's been in the local scene for years, and she's young too.
She's got a future, man. Trinity's a monster.
Yeah, dude.
I've never gotten a role with her yet, but I know she trains with like Stefan Christina. Love that dude. He's one of the few people out there that can triangle me consistently too.
Oh yeah.
He knows a counter to my pretty solid defense.
Yeah, I switched that passing up.
I love like I know like. It's so funny, like, when you hear a name, because you're like, oh, yeah, dude, like, I know that guy so well,
mm-hmm.
like, because we roll, like, I know so much about that guy, this is his style,
yeah.
everything, like, it's just so cool to see that, so I wonder, like, how often they, like, cross-train in MMA, like, I bet you it's a lot rarer.
Like, cross-training in MMA?
Yeah, man, because I feel like there's, like, in jiu-jitsu, like, you got these instructionals, and what is the lab... isn't as sacred it almost feels like. But,
right.
But, like, for MMA, there's so much changes to the meta, all the time.
Well, the culture's different, too.
Yeah,
it's not all, what's up, bro?
Yeah, dude.
Fucking it's go get more, acai after yeah, training. Yeah. Like, it's everybody's mean-mugging each other, you know what
yeah.
I mean? It's a little bit more, like, dog-eat-dog.
Yeah.
But that's how it has to be. It's fighting.
Yeah, dude. It's literally, we're about to watch some people try to kill each other.
Oh yeah, there's no like, oh, I ripped a submission too hard. Let me apologize to this guy. Like,
yeah,
it's you or me. It's...
Yeah, exactly, dude. For 5 minutes at a time, these guys are gonna try to wreak havoc on each other's bodies, like they've never done before.
Yeah, like I said, when I fought, it was everything that I thought it was gonna be plus more than I ever could have imagined.
Yeah,
you know, if you let certain things get to you, they will. But you know, I'm friends with so many fighters, and they all gave me really good advice before.
What was the best piece of advice you got leading up to your fight?
Oh man, I got so much.
Was there one that like resonated with you, like you thought of right before you walked in the ring?
Well, I'll tell you, the conversation that really made me realize that you know, this isn't a game is I was talking to my buddy James. He's a pro fighter. He was saying, he's like, dude, when you're back there and they're doing the rules meeting and the ref's telling you, don't stop hitting the guy until I tell you to stop. I don't care if he's knocked out. You know, that's real life. And also seeing the stretcher and the ambulance parked outside, all that stuff. Just realizing that, you know, it's a fight. It's not. It's way different than grappling or wrestling or anything
yeah.
else.
It's not a fucking game. In
it's
other
super
words.
Intense, man. But that's why they love it, man. It gives you that high. It gives you that adrenaline rush.
Yeah.
That's why these guys do it. They do it to feel alive. And I could see why. I could definitely
yeah.
see what the hype is about.
It's just hard, man. I have so much respect for people that put themselves in a position like this, man. Because you don't know you're going to win or lose, man, when you walk in there.
Yeah, I mean,
lose
it's
in front of your friends and family and get knocked the fuck out.
It's a 50-50 shot at best. You know, that's if you're at your best and they're at their worst. It's still 50-50.
Yeah. Have you ever heard that mantra that about the mental game where you know who's going to win or lose before they get in the ring based on the mental state of that individual?
Yeah. Where's that from?
I don't know who said that originally, but I know it's a popular like thing. Like,
I mean,
I've
it's
heard it many times.
It's true, man.
Yeah,
it is.
Yeah,
you know that, and the same kind of holds true for grappling. You know, there's a lot of really talented grapplers that do super high level stuff in the training room. Then when they go out and compete, maybe not even on a big stage, but just because they're competing and they know they have a lot of weight on their shoulders, they don't perform. A guy that I like to listen to, as far as talking about the mental game of fighting. And wrestling, because he teaches a lot of wrestling, is Chael Sonnen.
Yeah.
Chael Sonnen has touched on that subject a lot, and every like Chael Sonnen video that's like doesn't have a lot of views on YouTube where he's giving a speech, I click it and I watch the hell out of it, man.
Yeah. You know who I really like to watch too is the Karate Hottie, fucking
Michelle
Waterson. Like
what does she post?
Huh?
Oh, like
she's
her
a
fights,
monster, dude. Like,
yeah,
like,
man.
I just, like, I remember the one time I watched one of her fights, and You know where the first time I found out about her was Bully Beatdown. You remember that show, Bully
Beatdown?
I
know exactly what episode you're talking about. She beat the hell out of some chick.
Yeah, that fucking bully bitch.
Yup. With Jason Mayhem Miller.
Down, damn. Oh my God, it's so loud.
Man, gonna get our asses flagged, bro.
I know, man. He's trying to get this video flagged.
Let's see what's going on with UFC Fight Night. Let's see who's up now on that. Oh, that's the wrong app. Who else do you like to watch as far as fighting? Like, who's some of your favorite fighters?
We got the UFC over here, yeah.
Who's some of your favorite fighters you like to watch?
What's that?
What's some of your favorite fighters you like to watch?
My favorite fighters to watch? Dude, I loved Khabib. I really like Tony Ferguson, man. I think he's a super dynamic dude. Man. I'm about to go tell this DJ something really quick. How's that coming in through the headphone?
I mean, it's okay.
It's okay?
I mean, it's not bad. Sure. Hold on.
It's very loud to me out here.
Yeah, I really don't think it's interfering that much at all.
I'm just worried about the guys over here on the stream. I love Tony Ferguson lately, right? You know what's crazy? I have this story. It's funny. I wasn't a huge McGregor fan.
Right.
I didn't think he was a good representation of the sport. And I got respect for the man all day, right? Like, obviously, he's doing what he needs to do to get the most money. You got to be a personality, right? I got respect for that. But I wasn't a fan of the personality, right? And the fight style, I couldn't relate to it. It's not really how I fight, right? Anyway, I remember when he fought Nate Diaz. I was at a sports bar with my friend Matt. And when Nate fucking knocked him out, me and Matt stood up and we're just going, USA! And no one got in on it, yo. Like, everyone
were they
was
scared?
McGregor.
Because they're all McGregor
fans. Like,
come
on, he's an American, dude. McGregor's not even American.
Yeah, I know, right? Well, you know, it's like, When you're a dude like McGregor, I feel like it's just like he's doing his job, right?
Yeah.
At the end of the day, if you're in the UFC, your job is entertainment.
It is entertainment. I couldn't
especially if you're a consistent main card kind of athlete. And it's like, think about any other job that's not fighting. You know, the guys that don't really put in the extra work to become recognized, they're pretty easily forgotten, right? And they're not going to be the guys that are getting the promotions and the pay raises and stuff. The guys that put in the extra overtime and put in the extra work, and they have that little bit of X factor, they're going to be getting the money, and they're going to be remembered when they're gone, right? That's how it is with fighting. It's just a job at the end of the day.
Yeah. I got respect for it, man. What do you think about, like the current fighters, like that Peter Yan versus O'Malley, right? Like Sean O'Malley. I got mad respect for Sean O'Malley because he's a jiu-jitsu dude, man.
Yeah, I really like Sean O'Malley. I mean, not even about, you know, his personality or his antics, like, outside of the cage. Like, dude, the way he fights, I think it's so clean. He really has some of the most creative striking in the UFC.
Yeah.
I mean, who else is as creative as him? You could say, like, John Jones, but the cadence is just different.
I wouldn't compare many people to John Jones.
Right. I'm talking just as far as the distance striking in general.
Yeah, you think so?
A little bit, but O'Malley, honestly, he's faster. He has comparatively more power.
He's a very dynamic dude. Like, there's no doubt about it.
Like, obviously, John Jones can punch harder than Sean O'Malley.
Yeah.
O'Malley, there's no doubt about that.
Like,
but O'Malley's knocking people out.
Yeah, dude. It's just crazy, too. Like you think about, like, some of these heavyweights. Like, people don't understand how much a trained fucking hook can do.
Could
like,
you imagine what would happen if I sparred with a heavyweight for 1 minute, dude?
No way, dude. I would die.
I'd be in the fucking hospital before I realized what happened.
Like, the normal people don't understand, dude. Like, if you don't spar, you really don't get it.
Like, that's another thing. Like, you could be 140 pounds and then roll or wrestle with a heavyweight with no consequences. But if you're sparring,
dude,
like, with strikes
so
with a heavyweight,
difference.
Like, dude, you better think about what you're doing.
Because, like, one of the main things, too, is when the striking's involved, you need to react to a fucking heavyweight hitting you. Like, you're going to compromise position to defend, or else you're going to knock the fuck out.
Yeah, seriously.
It's fucking different animal, man. Who's the on the UFC card right now? Like, who's
let's
the
see. Okay, so I like this guy.
Card?
Okay, I'll give out the rest of the fights. So, coming up. So up next, we got Dustin Jacoby versus Khalil Roundtree. I really like Khalil Roundtree, man. He's a guy that I really like watching. He's pretty entertaining. So let me get this fight card. Dude, the ESPN, the interface is so broken, bro. I hate this fucking app.
You bet on the fights?
Here and there. I haven't recently. But when COVID was popping and I didn't have anything to spend my money on, dude, I was betting on a lot of fights.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I remember the happiest I was with a fight that I bet on was Frankie Edgar versus Pedro Munhoz. Frankie Edgar ended up winning, and I bet on him. I was just so happy. I felt like the smartest guy in the world because
I bet on him. How much money did you make on that bet? Woo!
Yeah.
Weld the money, baby.
So who else we got? We got Calvin Kattar versus Arnold Allen for the main event. That's interesting. That's a toss-up to me, but I'm gonna go ahead with Calvin Kattar for that one. We got Tim Means versus Max Payne Griffin. Who's this one? Oh, Jared Vandera versus a gentleman I've never heard of. Huh. And then we got, I think it's Trevon or Trayshawn Gore. I know I've heard of him before. He's fighting. He's really good. Oh, wow. Phil Hall's got knocked out by Roman Dolidze. I would never have guessed that. Have you ever seen Phil Hall's fight?
Who?
Phil Hall's.
What, move your finger? I don't know that guy. Can't say I recognize him.
Damn. But yeah, that main
Who's
event's
main
gonna
card?
Be crazy.
Who's the main fight?
The main card is Arnold Allen versus Calvin Kattar. Here's Arnold Allen right here is his little highlight.
Yeah.
Beating up Sadiq Yusuf.
What do you think about Patty the Batty?
I think he's good.
Dude, I think he looks like Andrew.
Yeah. I'll tell you who he looks like. He looks like my boy Brandon.
Yeah.
I'm gonna show you a picture real quick.
I think the violence is about to be underway.
Yeah, let's go.
And gentlemen.
Possibly some introductions for our first fight tonight.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Well, good evening, Lebanon, Pennsylvania.
Here we go.
Hype train boarding. On behalf of Arnold Gore, I am your cage announcer, Chuck Roberts.
Dude, the new Instagram, like display is horrible. Here's Patty the Batty right here. Oh, here, let me show you a picture when he was in high school.
Oh yeah, okay.
I went to high school with him. We used to train jiu-jitsu together. He boxes now.
That's cool.
Look. That's him.
Naga champ. Oh, shit.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Let's go, the belts.
Old school. Look, 2015.
Belts. Damn. The Naples brothers been cleaning it up since day one.
Yeah, dude, we were cleaning house at them local tournaments.
Got something leaking out of there.
Where?
Those shorts.
Holy shit. Let's get the camera on that. This ring girl is going crazy. Did you bring your tomatoes to throw in or around the cage?
Once again, flash photography is strictly prohibited. If you would like to take photos, please turn your flash off. It can be distracting to the fighters who have prepared so long and so hard to fight here tonight. So once again, please, the use of flash photography is strictly prohibited.
But you can taunt them all you want.
Yeah, right.
I can't wait, man. I haven't been a spectator to live fights in a few years now. I think the last live event I went to was Cowboy Fight Series in 2019.
Yeah.
Saw my friend Ben. He won the flyweight title. And my buddy James, who I was mentioning earlier, he won the 145 title down there right before they both went pro.
So for your fight, did you sit and watch any of the fights or anything? Like after your fight?
Like my fight?
Yeah, after your last Art of War.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah,
like
I would.
I watched my fight.
After I compete in jiu-jitsu. I mean, maybe it's different when you fight MMA, but after I fight jiu-jitsu, I just want to keep watching more violence, dude.
Yeah.
Especially after my bracket's over, I want to just keep staying involved with it.
Oh, shit, we're being assholes right now.
We're being assholes right now.
I
hold
know,
on.
We are. Oh, you want to stand for the thing?
We should.
All right, I agree. America, fuck yeah.
We are.
Oh, your brother's live over here.
Here's what we're gonna do. You're gonna count down from 10 with me.
What up, John?
Who's on here?
John Naples.
No shit, what'd he say?
He said Mackenzie like Brandon.
He heard us talking about Brandon. As I predicted, it's getting rowdy in here already.
Let's see some violence. Woo!
Yeah. So here we go, that 125-pound fight that I was talking about a little bit ago. We got Malik Danz making his walk. Out of Martinez, BJJ, we got Will Martinez and Matt Turnbull in the corner.
Folks, man. Every one of the Martinez guys won last Heart of War. So if I was a betting man, I think that's where I would put my money right out the gate on this first one.
Yeah, you know, if that's the only information that you have to go by, they're both making their debut, you know, because we don't know too much about his opponent.
Yeah. All right, man, we're getting underway, ladies and gentlemen. Hope you guys are ready. Unfortunately, if you're too broke to pay for the fights, all you're going to be able to do is hear us talk about it. But that's what we're here for, baby.
Which is fine. We'll do our best play-by-play.
Oh, the commissioner's yelling at something. Oh, man.
What else is new?
The PA Fight Commission doesn't play games, man.
We should say it here. I almost put a beer in... the ice bucket in the fighter's like warm-up area, and then I didn't at the last second because I realized that might get everything shut the fuck down.
Guess it.
Yeah. Like let me not put a beer in the fighter's fucking area.
Yeah. Let's see it.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the cage, Joseph.
Did you just see the referee yoke him up?
What the hell, dude?
Dude, he really gripped his ass up, dude.
Is that the commissioner?
Yeah, it is the commissioner,
dude.
They're looking at the hand wraps.
Out of control, dude.
You got to be careful with the flyweights, man. You almost gave him whiplash.
I know, man. My God.
I wish you guys could have seen that. This is a riot.
It was a little excessive, man. The fighter was running around the ring, and the commissioner just gripped him up and like yelled at him for his gloves or something like that.
Dude, whiplash is no joke. Jeremy Stevens fucking pushed. Who was it? Drake R. Close at a weigh-in. Drake R. Close.
He was trying to spook him like it's Halloween or something.
Yeah, Drake R. Close got whiplash, and they called the fight off.
The other guy too. All right, man. I'm excited. Here we go, man. We got the ring girls running around here.
Yeah, it looks like Michael Galen already made his walk. Both fighters are in the cage right now.
It's what's about to go down, boys. That dude's shredded, man. The white guy here.
Yeah, man, that dude probably cuts.
Yeah, a lot, man.
Introducing to you first, out of the blue corner to my right, he weighed in at 124.1 pounds. He represents Martinez BJJ. He is making his debut here tonight.
Both debuting here.
This is
Malik Gans. Blue shorts, I like it, man.
His opponent, out of the red corner to my left, he represents Bloomsburg MMA. He weighed in at 124.5
Two Pennsylvania guys.
And then from Millville, Pennsylvania, making his debut right here at AOW26, he is Joseph Galen.
Joseph Galen. It's gonna be a good match here, man. And they're both really wiry looking guys, right? Just long limbs. Both these 125
yeah,
pound guys, man. Just a lot of range. Probably going to be pretty scrambly if we're lucky. Yeah, you can take this.
I'll second that.
Yeah.
Recycle, save the planet,
you know.
Thank you.
Oh, here we go. First fight underway. Oh, man. All right, man. Looks like Malik's
caught.
Oh,
Joseph's
guillotine.
Guillotine. It's like he reverses the position.
Got some like half guard stuff going on right now against the cage as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, so Joseph's gonna be on top.
What do you think about like being up on a cage in like half guard? Like, what's your decision from there? Are you trying to get back toward the mat, or are you gonna use the wall?
If you're the top person.
If you're the bottom.
Well, if you're the bottom person, especially in these rules, I'm gonna try to get back to my feet.
Yeah. Okay.
Short rounds. You know, you can't afford to be on your back too long.
You want to get away from the cage then.
Yeah, because bottom half against the cage, you don't really have too much advantages.
Yeah, yeah. Throwing some knees and stuff. Them shin guards really protect you that much?
No.
Like the person getting hit?
No.
I feel like, yeah, man, that shit's still got to hurt them kids.
Even if you're getting kicked in the leg, man.
It's nice.
Man, I wish my fight went like this. We were just punching each other the whole time.
Right? You wish it would have went to the ground
yeah.
faster. Well, your opponent knew not to get there, man.
Yeah, that's a good point.
You started cleaning him up a little bit once you got there in your match. All right, you got like full mount going? What's going on here?
I can't tell. It looks like the angle that I'm at, the cage is kind of like preventing me from seeing
yeah,
exactly
this,
what
this
position they're in.
This bald dude's head's kind of screwing my angles up. Yeah, I think he's got a full mount thing going on. It's pretty good. Can you ground and pound as an amateur?
Not to the head.
Oh, dude, that's whack.
Yeah.
That's whack. Oh, no, he's got him back in a half guard, I think. Oh, man, what a pretty slow round, not going to lie.
Yeah, so it looks like Joseph Galen's going to take that first round. You know, I'm not a judge, and I have scorecards in front of me, but,
yeah.
You know, with these short rounds with the top control, that's usually the way it goes.
Yeah, man. I thought it was a good match, though. So far, they had a nice scramble in the beginning, at least. It's unfortunate that it kind of stagnated there, but it's only the beginning of the night. We're going to see plenty of blood, hopefully, here. I'm surprised in this day and age we don't have ring guys with the girls, you know? We got to have them equal rights.
Yeah, well, I think you just spoke it into existence. You're probably going to start seeing it pretty soon.
Yeah, no doubt. Yeah, man, it seems like the Martinez BJJ guys, man, they've been doing this a while, the MMA thing, you know?
Yeah, for sure. One of the top gyms in Philly. You know, obviously,
yeah.
They have the Dawkins brothers, who are both signed with the UFC.
Yeah, yeah. All right, here we go. Back at it. Ooh, okay, Malik.
Front kick.
Early,
it looked like it was almost to the face.
Yeah, yeah. Ooh,
oh!
Ooh, yeah, Malik, I'm favoring right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like it.
Dan's just landed a bomb.
All right. We've got a nice clinch action. A lot of knees flying here.
Yeah, they're both in the collar tie, just exchanging knees to the body.
Ooh, bro, that judo toss, though.
Yeah, but Malik's back up to his feet.
That was good, man. Good recovery. I like it. So far, so good. Okay, another one. Ooh, all right.
Yeah, he tried to bully Malik down with a front headlock throw. But he's actually going to, Joseph's actually going to end up on bottom.
Yeah, it looks like some kind of scarf hold kind of thing almost. It's kind of hard to see from here. Yeah, that's where he's at. Interesting. So you can't have a scarf hold and start knocking the guy? Like that counts as like
nothing to the head on the ground.
That's whack. No head strikes on the ground at all.
At all, nope.
Bro. What do you do then? Like, what's a good strategy in your opinion?
Grapple. Win the round.
Yeah. Because you're not going to go for, like, gut strikes too much, right?
No, you can, you know.
Maybe, like, if you can get that liver, I feel like you got to be accurate to even hunt for that, though.
You know, there's a little bit of a dilemma with the knees to the body. Knees to the body are a great option, but you got to think. When you're lifting your leg, you know, that high off the mat, you're compromising your base, giving them a chance to move a little bit more than you'd like them to. Knees to the body, as good as an idea as they sound like without being able to strike to the head, it's a risk.
Yeah, no doubt, man. Okay, looks like we maybe got a Darce going here.
So it looks like the tables might have turned a little bit for Malik here. He's winning this round.
Malik's on top now, yeah.
Pretty comfortably.
Yeah, I hope I get an invitation to go train at Martinez soon. Yeah. Man. I got to drop in for an open mat over there or something.
I was going to say, we're not like ringside commentary on stream, so like, we can let it fly. We can say who we think's winning without any like repercussions. Nice knee to the body by Malik again.
A lot of knee to the body stuff.
Yeah, for sure.
Can you do like a flying knee? Is that legal in amateur?
Just not to the head. No, like the only thing you could throw to the head in amateur
really
MMA in Pennsylvania
the heads of these
is punches.
All right, let's make some noise. Let's hear from the lovely Mickey.
Nice.
All right, third and final round. You know, if I had to guess, I'd say they're 1-1.
Good stuff, man. It's exciting, man. What are some things, like, when you're taking rest rounds in an MMA fight, like, what are some things you're looking for from your coach? Like, you like when they, like, dump the ice on your head and shit like that?
Yeah, to be honest, Danny was spraying my face with water, and I don't know. For some, I wasn't feeling it. He did it once towards the end of the break. I was like, no more of that. Like, stop. You put the ice on my shoulders and shit. Get that shit out of my face, though.
Yeah.
I don't know. Some people like it.
That's good to know, man. All right, man. I want to see like a good like fucking hook. Just drop the guy.
Little nice right hook by Malik there.
Okay, we got some kicks coming from Joseph now.
Yeah, they're
as well.
Exchanging hard body kicks.
Okay.
That was a really good time shot by Joseph.
Okay. All right, we're up on the cage now.
Yeah, so Malik had his leg jacked up, but he was still throwing punches. Oh, wow.
That's good, man. A lot of standing on this last round here. This is a quick rounds, man. Okay, all right, we're going to get a dump on a suplex. Yeah!
Oh, no fucking way.
That's awesome, dude.
Wow, this is
a
beautiful
dump,
suplex by right. Joseph Galen.
Oh, shit, dude, that was good. That was excellent. All right, yeah, man, so...
So it looks like Joseph Galen ends up on bottom. He got a little bit too antsy with the back take after that suplex. We're going to see Malik on top now.
I give him points for that. That suplex was excellent. The execution was great. Unfortunately, people are standing, so it's pretty hard to see.
Yeah, Malik is in full mount. It looks like he's setting up a mounted triangle, but Joseph might be a little bit too far on his shoulders for him to do it. So Malik Danz has an inverted triangle.
That triangle's tight, dude.
This is sick. Really good grappling exchange.
What a fight, man. That was a great grappling exchange, man.
So now, if the round ends like this, who's taking this round? Because Joseph Galen had a really big moment with that suplex, but we got Malik here in a dominant position. Okay, Joseph's out now. He's gonna elect to stand up. They're gonna meet in the center of the cage, exchanging punches. Joseph caught him with a jab, off balance Malik a little bit. 10 seconds.
Yeah, back on the feet, man.
Malik just got cracked with a right hand,
okay,
and he ducks under.
Oh, yeah, man.
One final takedown, not quite.
Joseph had some excellent wrestling there, man. That was excellent wrestling from Joseph there.
Yeah, you know, that was a great little scrap.
Yeah. I don't know who you giving it to on your. I loved the suplex, but as we saw, Malik was able to reverse it and get on top, and then hit him with that triangle, man.
Dude, it was definitely one and one going into the third. You know, he had the suplex. Malik had that submission attempt with the inverted triangle. But I'll tell you what, Joseph really did land a hard right hand at the end of that third round. So
yeah,
it's little things like that you have to look out for as a judge. We'll see. If I had to guess, I don't know.
Yeah, tough call. Tough call, man. I thought it was an excellent fight toward the end there. It started slow, but that was an incredible way to end it. That suplex was beautiful.
Yeah, it was nuts.
I haven't seen something like that in a very long time.
It was like the perfect amount of striking and grappling in one fight.
Yeah. Yeah, these guys, I hope both have nice foothold as they move on with the rest of their career. Obviously, they both just, this is their debut fight. For both of these guys, so I'm really, really hoping to see some excellent stuff come out of them in the future.
Malik smiling like he acknowledges to his team that he thinks he did enough to earn the decision. We'll see.
Man, judges have a tough job, dude.
It is
how
very
they
hard.
The strikes. Like, is there like a counter? Like, do you have like one of those thumb oscillating things?
Probably not for an event like this. I mean. Well, dude, that's not done at the event either. Like, when you see, like, ESPN, you see this right here.
UFC, yeah.
Like, that's done, like, remotely, like, probably thousands of miles away.
Oh, yeah, you think so? I believe you.
All right, official decision.
First off, let's hear it for these two fighters going all three rounds.
That was awesome, man.
To the judges' scorecard we go. Judge one scored this bout 29-28 in favor of Gingland.
Oh, we got a split decision.
Judge two scored this bout right. 30-27 in favor of Gans.
All right.
Judge three scored this bout 29-28 in favor of your winner by split decision, Joseph.
Yeah, man, that suplex did it.
Joseph Duffy takes it by split decision. But you know what's really interesting about that decision? It was a split for Joseph, but one of the judges saw a 30-27 for Malik.
Interesting.
We got some boos from the crowd now.
The crowd is pissed, man. There's a lot of Martinez guys in here, I think, that thought it went the other way.
Yeah.
I feel like, man, I wish Malik could have finished that triangle. You know, could have got it done.
He got to a really good position right after getting slammed on his head, which is very impressive. So here we go. Moving back to UFC, we got Khalil Roundtree.
Who do we got here?
Khalil Roundtree and Dustin Jacoby. They're banging it out. It's the third round. Look at Khalil striking, dude.
Oh my god.
He just got whacked with a head kick, but
still. Head kick. Yo, what do you think about leg kicks, man? Is that why they have the shin guards? Can you leg kick an amateur?
I think they have shin guards so they don't get their shins busted the fuck up. Yeah.
Leg kicks scare the shit out of me, dude.
Why?
I just feel like you can tap out of a heel hook.
Right.
But you can't tap out of a fucking leg kick that's going to bust your knee up, man.
You can sit down after you get whacked with one.
Oh, man. I don't know. Nothing but carnage here.
So they're
how quickly they're going to send the fighters out. I think I'll wait one more fight, and then I'm going for a pee break, I think.
I was thinking the same thing.
Do you want to run now?
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's do it. All right, guys, we'll be right back. All right, guys. Eric's still in the bathroom. But we got Alex Estevez, I believe.
Your referee is David Osugi.
Wait. I don't know. Let me see. I think my list might be a little out of order. I didn't hear the names. I'll wait till Eric gets back. He's got the card. But yeah, we're gonna cover this one right here, baby. Early start. These guys are a little heavier. I feel like that. Information on my list is definitely wrong. Ooh, a slugfest, man. These guys are boxing it out, man. Just beating the shit out of each other, man. Just a slugfest, straight up. Beautiful. Got some wall wrestling going, a lot of knees. And I believe these guys are also in the amateur because they have the shin guards. I don't think every match here is amateur, but I could be wrong. Man, a lot of kind of cage wrestling. Got the red corner guy wants that fucking takedown, man. Ooh, reversed it, man. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. A lot of great work on the feet from these guys, man.
Let him go, Dylan!
Eric's on his way back right now. Eric, can you double check the names for this? I don't think the names that I got here for 145. These guys look heavier than 145. I don't think that's these guys. They might have the order a little off. But so far, man, slugfest. I don't know if you've seen it so far, man. These guys are just at war with each other a minute ago. What are you thinking here from Black Shorts? Like, what's your idea for a strategy?
Exactly what he did. Press him against the cage. See if we could trip him up.
Got that mount clean, dude. Ooh. Oh, he going for a Kimura?
Yeah, it looks like it was short time. We got less than 5 seconds in this round.
Yeah, you're probably not gonna get the submission in that time. Oh, but he's giving him some rib love. Bopped him up. You have any idea on the names of these guys? Oh man, what's going on? Mike taking a fight or something? Nah. Rough. All right, what do we got here?
A man.
I think this might be John Alwine versus Yajaziel Estrada.
Looking a little gassed in the blue corner.
They gotta be like around that size. 170, right? That's what they look like. They're walking around 170.
You'd be surprised, man. Dude's cut.
Yeah.
And they look bigger than what the number on the scale actually says.
Yeah.
All right, fans, make some noise and let's hear it for round number two.
All right, here we go. Here we go, second round. A lot of moving, a lot of touching. Man, dude, they just slugging, bro.
Holy shit.
Completely different dynamic from the last match. Just throwing bombs. These guys got to be 170, bro. You think they're lighter? There's no way. They're big.
God damn. Yeah, they're in the pocket, man.
Uppercut would have been nasty.
Man, I wish we could turn the camera to
gave him a little love right there. Man, I love watching a fight, man.
For sure.
Just piecing him up pretty good, man. It's a good exchange, man. I think it's pretty tough to say who's winning here.
I'm thinking someone's getting dropped by the third round, dude.
It looks like the bald guy, I don't know about you, but it kind of looks like he's kind of telegraphing a little bit. Like, he does the same kind of, like, ramp up before he charges in every time.
Yeah, I would agree to a certain extent. But part of it is he's trying to time his takedowns.
Yeah, of course.
Well, you see, he just stuffed one right there. Now he's got him pressed up against the cage.
Yeah.
Little pot shots. He might be hunting for a front headlock attack.
He's swarming him pretty good. He's got him trapped against the cage there. Excellent, man. We got the guillotine.
Yeah. Oh, he slapped on a guillotine right at the bell.
That was where he wanted to be, man. These are quick rounds. What's the time limit on these? These ain't even 3 minutes.
Two. Yeah.
Was that your fight? It was 2 minutes rounds?
Man. 2 minute rounds.
I might do some amateur MMA. Only 2 minutes. I can hang that. Probably not.
Yeah, Delaware is three.
Is it?
And I think Virginia.
See, it's a Pennsylvania thing. That's why it's two.
Pennsylvania and.
Dude, that's whack.
I think New Jersey's three, too. I think PA is the only one with 2 minute rounds.
You can't get brain damage in 2 minutes. I guess that's why.
Right. Dude, yeah, Virginia is full on pro rules from the get go.
Yeah? For amateur, it's just the same rule set?
What's this dude doing? You see that?
He's just getting in on that pocket.
That wasn't even the pocket, dude.
Dude over here grabbing his girl's butt as close as he can.
Dude, his hand was in her pants. This is comical.
Alright, here we go. Let's make some.
Getting a little too excited over there.
I've never seen anything like that. That was fucking hilarious.
Alright. Get that grease, boy. Let's get that grease. That's good, man. Oh, he's gassing.
Damn, dude.
Black shorts, my man in the red corner is a little gassed.
Looks like.
But I've been there, man. Like, sometimes when you're gassed out on the feet, man, you just got to fucking throw a takedown, dude.
Yeah.
I just got to get this to the ground. I resonate with this, actually. So they're only allowed to strike hands to the face, right? No bows.
Nope.
Tame rule set.
No elbows at all for amateurs, whether it's amateur or advanced amateur.
You can't do any elbows.
No. There are two different amateur rule sets. If you have three or more fights as an amateur, you'll do what's called advanced amateur rules.
Yeah.
They'll allow, like, head kicks.
Yeah.
But still no elbows.
Yeah. Man, they're getting it in, dude.
Gunning for a rear naked choke, are we against the fence? It's got to be about 30-ish seconds left in this fight.
It's pretty good, man. So it looks like this is the first time we're seeing someone actually try to dominate with striking from, like, the top mount instead of going for a submission. He's just throwing bombs on him.
Yeah, man. That's a really strong way to end a fight, just being on top, just punishing him with body shots.
As far as a decision goes, it's pretty obvious where it's got to go for the strike count, right?
Dude, I mean, you don't know. We saw a judge give 30-27 to Malik in that last fight, and he ended up losing, so.
Yeah.
Sometimes people just see it a completely different way.
True, man. It was excellent, man. That was a slugfest, dude. They were just throwing bombs the whole time.
Yeah, it was a pretty good scrap.
It was nice.
I hope all the fights tonight are like this.
Yeah. I hope we see more of that. How many ounces are the gloves?
I think six.
Six?
Yeah.
That's thin, dude.
I think the pros are four.
Really?
Yeah.
Yikes.
God knows what the shin pads are. I don't know if that even matters. I think they're just I think they're just for show, dude.
Yeah. They're just for show. What do you think about, like, the bare knuckle boxing and like MMA that they have going on these days? It's getting popular.
I like the bare knuckle. I think it's really entertaining. I mean, I'm all over the place with it. Entertaining, yes, but, like, it's kind of degrading. Like, when you go from UFC to bare knuckle boxing, like, it's so brutal. It's so much more brutal than MMA.
Yeah, because the knuckles are just cutting the face open, dude.
And
so
dude,
easily.
I was talking to somebody about this. Let's see the decision first. All right.
Dude,
you called it.
They were 145.
Yeah.
So it skipped one, and we're on Alex Komatic versus Komatic versus Dylan Beaver. Sorry for not having those names right for you guys earlier.
Yeah, so Alex Komatic will take that one. And it was a slugfest in the second round for sure, but you know that top control in the third really secured it for him.
Yeah,
but what I was saying about the bare knuckle is it's because the guys are so afraid of the bone-on-bone, they're afraid of not only getting their hands broken, but their face fucking broken, too.
You got to strike softer with a bare knuckle.
Yeah, well, no, they're swinging, but it's just a lot sloppier, in my opinion.
We see our lovely AOW ladies. They're out on the outer side here in the main lobby. Or, excuse me, here in the main arena area, just outside the lobby. With the AOW
Grappling TV. We got Max in the house. Thanks for the shout outs, my man. You know I love you, baby.
With that, ladies and gentlemen, AOW 26 action continues.
All right, I'm getting a brewski, dog.
About to make his way to the cage. Please welcome Jahaziel Reyes.
Jahaziel Reyes is our next fighter here. We're going against John Alwine. And these are 170 guys. So the last guys were 145. That's crazy. They look so big for that size.
Yeah.
They definitely were cutting from like.
Well, here's a 170 pound matchup
weight,
coming
probably.
At you right now,
yeah.
Right?
It's crazy how much some of these dudes cut, man. It's wild.
Yeah, even for amateur, man. This the sport's changing.
Yeah.
Nice.
You want one?
Sure, man. Awesome, thank you.
X's gonna give it to you.
And now, about to make his way to the cage, please welcome Jack Alwine.
This is a great song right here. I think this was my walkout song for a
that
match.
That was your walkout
Not
song?
For the fight, but for a match.
Yeah,
I can't remember
that's
when. Yeah, maybe for Fury Grappling. Yes, for Fury Grappling, this is my walkout.
Oh, man, we got some fans out here, man. Dude, these guys are big. Thick boys or medium-sized boys.
Right. I don't know, pretty big dudes to be fighting at 170. I mean, comparatively, you know what I mean? I'm 128 fucking pounds.
Where do you think you get the concentration of the most skill in MMA?
It's hard to say, man. I mean,
a lot of people think the lighter you go, the more skills required.
There's definitely an argument for that, but then there's some really good technicians at 205 and 285 or 265 rather.
Of course, yeah. I mean, at the top level, you're going to get a lot of that.
Look at Cyril Gagne. He's one of the most technical strikers in the UFC.
Yeah.
Well, he lost to Ngannou, but he completely took apart...
Well, Francis Ngannou's a fucking monster, too.
Yeah, he completely took Tai Tuivasa apart, you know?
Tuivasa's a fucking beast, too.
I do love me some Tuivasa.
All right, man.
The following contest is an amateur bout set for 3 2-minute rounds of war. This contest is brought to you by the Board of
I love how he said 3 2-minute rounds of war.
Isn't that so weird?
Oh, Jersey boy.
Doity Joycey.
There we go.
Yeah, it's getting loud in here.
Where do you say you fight out of? You say Delaware?
Yeah.
You don't say New Jersey?
No, I live in Delaware. I wake up in the morning, I put my shoes on from Delaware to wherever the fuck I'm fighting, so
right.
I'm fighting out of Delaware. That's where I eat, sleep, and shit, so.
Yeah. See it. All right, man. Here it comes. All right, here we go. Here we go. Ooh, all right, all right. Strong approach. Just to hit the brakes.
Yeah, hard leg kick kicks. by John in the red corner over here. Ooh.
Ooh, dump him. Dump him. Beautiful. Josh Zeal. Oh, my God. Josh Zeal's cleaning it up, dude.
Right. John's got a good cross face, but he loses it because he a little bit too much of an angle. He's got his back against the cage now.
I like it, though. So a lot of potential right here, right? Because we got a... So, like, we got the underhook on the cage, but my man's trying
to
reverse.
And you see that, how he's trying to get his hands connected?
I like this. Okay, yeah, but we're down.
And dumps him.
What kind of grappling stuff is illegal? So we can't do leg locks, right? What else?
I mean, you can't do toe holds and heel hooks.
You can straight ankle?
Yeah, not that I would want to in shin guards, but...
Yeah. There's a lot of protection there. Yeah, there definitely is.
Yeah, and even with gloves, man, your straight ankle has to be 100% perfect.
No doubt.
You don't have a 10-minute round like you do in a grappling match to really get that thing right.
100%. Oh, man, we got Yajzeel on the back, dude.
Yep.
John's in trouble, man. Gave up his back. We're getting threats from strikes and rear naked choke here.
Yeah, probably about 45 seconds left in this round here.
As much time as you can ask. Oh, my God, dude. That shit is sunk. Oh, there we go, man. He's got that rear naked choke sunk in.
10 seconds.
Oh, he's got 10 seconds.
The sticks just sounded. So it looks like John Alwyn's going to see a second round.
The gloves are in the way.
Yeah.
Couldn't get it done.
If you're gonna fight amateur, you know, without being able to punch in the face to set up your submissions, you better have a nasty face crush.
Yeah, right.
You better be drilling that.
Everything under the what is it? Everything under the eyes.
The nose. Some people say eyes. Yeah. Some other people say nose.
The nose.
I'm not choking the nose though. That'd be pretty hard.
Yeah. The nose. Everything under the nose is the neck. You take the ice. You take the ice on you though. I know you said the spray.
Ice feels good.
The water spray ain't the move. But.
Nah, this shit pisses me off. But ice feels pretty good.
Yeah, cause you're pretty fucking high temperature, right? You're fucking firing on all cylinders in there. You're redlining for 2 minutes at a time.
I mean, how I look at it, the sweat's already cooling me down. My body's already doing its job.
Yeah.
You're just sitting here trying to fucking drown me with the water in my mouth and my eyes and shit.
That makes sense. Yeah. Dude, I feel like I would want a shower right after this. You didn't get a shower after your shit?
I don't want to talk about my shower routine after my fight. I went to Applebee's and I got pretty lit up, and then I really think I just went to my hotel and crashed.
Yeah. That back kick was nice.
Yeah. Ooh, he dropped him with a leg kick. John Alwyn just got dropped with a leg kick.
Yeah, Jiujitsu just really capitalized and punished John for a pretty. He left himself open. I can't remember exactly what he did.
Yeah, he threw an overhand right. He had all his weight on his lead leg, which would be his left.
Yeah, he got punished for that pretty well. Jiujitsu did a really excellent job of closing the deal with that. Punched him with a good punch from. Leaving himself open and then really swarmed him with a nice, I think it was like a double leg or something. They're on the cage right now. It's excellent.
Yeah, so when you get chopped with an inside leg kick, if you have all your weight on that leg, that's going to be way nastier than if you have none of your weight. Of course, it'll slap it really hard, and that bone's going to be digging into the knee. But, man, when you have weight involved, it's just a different animal. That's when the ligaments can start to get fucked up.
Yeah, no doubt.
people are giving me funny looks when I'm swearing because I think they think that this is like the actual like live stream commentary. Could you imagine?
Yeah, dude. That's funny as shit.
These guys are unprofessional. I didn't come here to hear that.
Man, they're just stagnant, man. They're stagnant on the cage.
Yeah.
I think Yajzeel obviously won this round, man.
Yeah, I've been saying it all night. You know, short rounds, whoever's on top essentially wins that round.
Checks out.
And if not, one solid submission attempt, if that's all you have time to do, that's what you go by. There go the sticks again.
All right, man. Yeah, man. Yajzeel's really celebrating here.
No way.
He's convinced that he got it.
Did he tap?
I don't think he did. I don't think he did tap.
Yeah. Look.
Oh, maybe he did. I don't fucking know. I don't think he did, dude. I didn't see the ref stop it. I think he was just convinced that he won. But I could be wrong. We'll hear the decision. That was a nice fight, though. Definitely like a lot of like tactical stuff coming from both of these guys.
Well, the way that they were yelling, it makes me think that he tapped. That it was like definitive.
Yeah, man.
Definitely
he was,
finished.
He was extra excited. I mean, you just match the energy of the guy you choose in the ring too. If he's just convinced he won and he just celebrated like that.
Yeah.
Know? It's kind of like when you win a jiu-jitsu match and by winning by 2 points and you just scream.
Oh,
and
yeah.
And your team gets hype, you know.
I can honestly say that I've never done that after winning on points.
That's funny as hell.
I'm like too busy admiring my own work on the scoreboard. Like, damn. 13-0, that's pretty good. I'm just staring. I'm not. What are you going to celebrate for? You didn't finish the guy.
All right, man. This was not a debut match, right?
Yes, it was. Told you. He tapped him.
Rear naked choke finish. Way to go, man.
Jiujitsu Reyes is going to take it by submission. I couldn't tell because of the angle. When they're on the left side of the cage, it's very hard to tell what's going on.
Yeah, you got the door
because
that's
of
in
that
the way
door.
Of people's heads. So if they're on the floor over here, it's pretty tough to see. It's unfortunate they keep ending up over there, too.
Right. I knew he was on his back, but I couldn't tell if he tapped or not, and it was getting close to the end of the round. See what's going on with UFC.
Yeah, man. Let's see it.
Who's fighting now?
Dropping some frames over here.
Looks like Trayshawn Gore just won by Ninja Choke. That's like the power guillotine. It's essentially it's a guillotine with a rear naked grip. Yeah.
What's that called?
Ninja choke, they call
ninja
it.
Choke.
I know it as a power guillotine.
And we're going to award those at the end, just before our press conference, which will take place if you're all invited to stick around and be part of right out here in the main arena area.
Mike did mention to us as well to jot down any questions that we have for.
Yeah, that's a good one. Well, there's no telling who will show up to the press conference. Some guys are hurting and they just get up on out of here.
I'm gonna jot some notes down. Oh man, my category's pets and animals on this stream. That's not right. Let me see if I can change that.
What's that?
My category is set to pets and animals for
oh,
some
wow,
reason.
That's whack.
Oh, man. That's funny. Let's change it to sports here. That's hilarious. YouTube has some dumb defaults.
It makes no sense. Like, why would that be the default?
Right?
How can I see the live chat from my phone?
Now,
or can I not? All right, our next fight coming up.
Let him know.
We got Bradley Eisenhower versus Kenny Jacquinore. I'm hoping I'm pronouncing that right.
Should be a good one. Should be a good one. I like his walkout music. Some Avenged Sevenfold.
This one's going to be at 175-pound catch weight. Oh, yeah, there's Bradley Eisenhower. I think we spoke to him briefly in the back, right?
What's that?
I was going to say, I think we briefly spoke to him in the back room.
Yes, I believe we did.
Three two-minute rounds of war.
War. He represents UFC Jim and hails from Lancaster, Pennsylvania, making his debut right here at AOW 26.
You know what's interesting? Not all of those UFC gyms do MMA. Some of them are just like lifting gyms. It's silly.
Or like they have like
the cardio kickboxing shit. It's silly. Like, way to capitalize on your brand and, like, market it to normies the best way you could. Like,
I know they're...
I guess.
Let me not say too much on camera, but, yeah, I got my opinions on some of the UFC gyms.
Yeah.
Eisenhower's bringing the hype behind him. He got the crowd. He got the crowd
by
in
default,
his favor.
I gotta go for Brad because it's his name. We got Bradley Eisenhower versus Kenny Jacquinore. I think is how you pronounce his last name. Oh, I like his orange shorts though. Kenny's got some Goku vibes right here. He's about to charge the Kamehameha.
Hard leg kick from Brad.
Nice. Ooh,
nice
like
check right
nice
hook
swarmy.
As he's going forward.
These guys are heavy too, 175. Just jacked, man. Nice and bouncy.
Oh,
okay.
Kenny
clean,
got
clean
sloppy. Got cracked with the
Brad.
Right hand. It's like.
Way to rep the Brad core. Let's go.
Yo, Brad's going off.
I like it, man. He's dropping some bombs.
Yeah, they're having fun in there.
They're having fun in there. We're having a good time. So I saw the dude outside the cage wiping the gel and shit on the face.
Yeah.
Tell me about that, man. Like, what's that material? What does it do for you?
It's just Vaseline. It's just pretty much so it makes it easier to not get cut from punches,
really?
At least. Yeah. Is
that the main purpose of it?
Yeah, it's so you don't get cut.
That was not my assumption. Oh, we got a leg lock.
Oh, wow.
We got a leg lock entry.
Yeah, Brad just rolled under for a knee bar.
Oh, knee bar?
Is he going to get it? Looks like he's slipping it a little bit.
Dude, that was sick, man. He did like an inversion, and I think he's going for a knee bar. Brad's going for a knee bar on Kenny here. Wow, dude. Kenny's punishing him for the attempt, though. Really giving him mad rib shots here. Wow, he got out. Well, that was excellent. That was an excellent display. Very technical exchange. Nice, man. Both recovered, back on the feet. That was a nice exchange. Very cool. It's awesome, man. Like, you get to see some very technical stuff at these amateur fights. Because like these guys probably specialized in one martial art before they decided to do the MMA route.
Yeah,
so
definitely.
So they're experts somewhere before they got here.
That's why you see the clash of styles more in amateur MMA than professional.
Yeah. Gotta love it, too, you know? Even in your match, right? Like, pro grappler, pro striker.
Yeah, that's basically what it was.
Let's go, man. That was a great match.
And there's no
what did you think of that inversion, man? It was weird. It was almost like a I don't even know what to call that.
You know,
like a forward roll.
Yeah, it was Gary Tonin does it a lot. It's almost like a Granby when somebody has your back from standing position.
Yeah.
Tactically, it was a very good move. I mean, Brad was winning that round before, so he took a little bit of a risk, dropped down for the leg lock. So now he's got some good significant strikes going for him. Plus the leg lock attempt could have sealed him the round.
Do you, in your opinion, like if you had to guess, like how many strikes is a good grappling submission attempt worth?
That's such a big debate because we saw it in that O'Malley and Jan fight, right?
Yeah, dude.
It was.
Oh, people were mad.
Oh, I know. I read comments. I don't know, man. It depends on what it does to you. You could be landed bombs and it not hurt the guy, but you know you could also just jab the dude and it drops him.
Yeah.
That's dropping somebody's definitely more than a takedown with a little bit of control, in my opinion.
And you could have a sub where you just rip the arm and the guy just keeps fighting.
Right.
Injured, fighting on a broken, injured limb.
Yeah, dudes don't tap. You got to really break them off or put them to sleep.
Damn, what happened? Was that like a?
It's like looks like Brad lost his balance. It doesn't look like he got dropped. But he was stepping.
Not looking the best for Brad in round two here.
Yeah, he was stepping back. He got caught with a left hook and he stumbled. So he's gonna find his back on the mat against the cage over here.
Looks like Kenny got a scarf hold. Nice. Nice position for Kenny. It's a really, really terrible angle for us.
Yeah, we got a lot of people standing up.
Oh, yeah. It's not helpful.
Yeah. You want one? Take a holographic one.
Oh, the holos ain't out there, bro.
No?
Guests only.
For guests.
Guests only. You can have any other one, though. Or take a couple. I don't care.
Sure.
That was good. Oh, okay.
Wow. I missed it. What did
he
hit him with?
Brad caught the W. Unfortunately, we were unable to see it. yo,
He's
my man
hyped.
Is so hyped. I love it, dude.
He's
that
hyped.
Energy. There's something so fucking beautiful about that, man. God, I love that. That's awesome, man. Congratulations to the man. Way to go. Did you see what he ended up winning with?
I was talking to the
chick
sticker about the
lady.
Stickers, and I was like, I looked up, and he Brad's sitting there with his hands up.
That's awesome, man. He's so happy.
Yeah,
that,
man.
That was so beautiful. I love to see a team get together and see, like, all that. Because, it's hard for people to understand. Like, so there's so much work every day of the week. You're going in to train with your group, and you're like, I'm going to war, and I need you guys to prepare me. And you got to see it pay off. It's awesome, man.
I mean, even the amateurs.
There's something so you can taste it. It's
when they're
beautiful.
When they're taking it seriously, they're making so much sacrifices.
Yeah. For like no money, right? Like.
Yeah.
It's crazy. Warrior shit. Woo! Hype train boarding. Man, what a great battle. That first round was great too, man. I love that inversion.
Yeah, it looks like Kenny's limping a little bit.
Excellent exchange that entire time.
I really don't know what the sub was.
Yeah, we'll find out here in a moment. Yeah, next time we're going to have to make sure we... I wish they had that projector going. We'd be able to see everything.
I know, they're having issues with that thing.
All right, we're about to find out, ladies and germs. Brad caught the W. Representing the Brad Corps. Let's go.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contest came to a close at 54 seconds in round number two.
54 seconds, round number two.
From the triangle choke by the legs.
Via the triangle choke from the legs.
Triangle choke from the legs.
What a weird way to describe that.
Yeah, man, this is... Jesus Christ. As opposed to what?
What's that?
As opposed to what? You know what I mean?
Transmission.
You can't say transmission, dude.
Could you imagine if like a UFC like commentator said that? They would get roasted for weeks.
Oh, for sure. You have to quit.
All right, Brad Eisenhower gets the sub by triangle.
Way to go, Brad.
Yeah, good for him.
Way to get it done.
Triangle choke by the legs. Said it
again.
Ladies and gentlemen, you guys have a good time here tonight.
Is that, dude, that's Mac Miller that just walked by us.
What's that?
Mac Miller just walked by us.
That's not Mac Miller.
I swear to God, back. Look. Right here.
That's not fucking Mac Miller.
You're telling me that's not Mac Miller?
It's not fucking Mac Miller.
Yeah, it was. You can't tell me I wasn't Mac Miller. You heard it here, guys at home. Triangle choke by the legs.
By the legs. Lit.
By the legs.
Oh, we're going to do like a hologram Tupac? Is that what's going on right now?
All right.
Turn it up. Uh-oh.
All right, live from heaven, Pop Smoke. No shit.
Jackson. No.
Oh my God, bro.
It's fucking Michael Jackson.
What the fuck? Holy shit.
They got fucking Michael Jackson in the house. Let's go.
Dude. So
what's
there
he gonna do?
There is a Michael Jackson impersonator in the cage, and he is going absolutely sicko
right, so,
mode.
So we got Michael Jackson in the ring right now. About to get my fucking video flagged with this music.
Dude, I'm not gonna lie, he's low-key killing it.
Damn, bro. I hope he wiped his shoes off before he got in there. Respect the mats.
What the fuck?
It's different.
Oh, man.
You ever see halftime shows at the UFC? Is that not a thing?
I don't think so. I'm going to... If you guys want to see what's going on, you can check my Instagram story right now. I'm going to post this.
All right, guys.
The goddamn... Oh, there we go. Yeah.
Let's go.
Oh, no.
He's going in.
Yeah, what?
He really brought Michael Jackson back. Show the camera. Show the camera. Show the camera.
We get this shit fucking copyright infringed, bro.
Give me that. Show the camera.
All right, here. It's on the next slide. Glare. Oh, man. Yeah, you can see him. You can see him. Yeah, so that's what we're watching. I'll tell you what.
Make sure you guys follow Eric on Instagram, though, for real. He posts some good stuff.
On that note,
this is not the exception to the rule.
I'm going to go take a 2-minute long piss, and then I'm going to eat some of my protein bar.
Yeah, I think let's take a little break here. We're going to take a little intermission while they're taking an intermission here. Going to grab some snacks. Stand by, y'all. Get your name in here really quick. Is that spelling right for your name?
There's no E. There's no E in the first name.
Oh, my bad.
Really?
There's no E in your first name?
Yeah,
same,
that's
dude.
How my mom spelled it.
Yeah, dude, I'm the same way, actually. It's unique. Most people have the EY. So, yo, I got Brad Eisenhower in the house. Yo, Brad, here, I'm going to pull the mic for you a little bit here. Eric will probably come. I got another mic for him.
Sweet.
Dude, congratulations on the win, man. We couldn't see you that well. Like, as you can see, you can imagine the fucking line of sight wasn't the best for your spot, man.
Yeah.
But you did excellent.
Player,
yeah,
excellent.
Yeah, dude, it was such a good fight, yeah.
Thank you.
Here, Eric, I'm going to pull you up on that mic here.
Yeah, man.
Yo, so, dude, excellent match, man. You came in swarming, man. I fucking loved the intensity right out the gate, man. And then you finished in, like, a dominant fashion, man. What did you do to prepare for the fight? Was this your debut?
No,
did I hit that right?
No, my first fight, I actually lost to an armbar.
Okay.
Well, I came out the same way. My first fight, I came out swinging. I pieced him up like I did Kenny.
Yeah, yeah.
And so he took me down all three rounds. My wrestling wasn't there. So for this camp, I did a lot more wrestling and a lot more jiu-jitsu. And got it there, as you can see, went for the rolling knee bar.
Yeah, dude, I like leg locks myself, yeah. Dude. I fucking love that. It was a beautiful entry.
You're
definitely piecing him up early. So like Eric was saying during your match, he's like, he definitely is in the lead, so he could afford to make a risky move like that.
I knew. I wanted to ask you something too. I saw that Kenny was limping a little bit in between the first and second round. Was the knee bar tight? Was it on at all, or did you have to let it go?
It wasn't. I didn't have the right angles off to the side, and my hips were too far up on his thigh. I needed to come down more towards his knee, so I didn't have it. That's why I let it go. I didn't try to fight for it, and I was fucking tired after.
Yeah.
I was tired after we stood up, if you guys could tell.
Yeah, I imagine.
Yeah.
He was getting after your ribs, right? I think I saw it, man. Yeah.
Yeah. So, I can't believe I got that fucking triangle, though.
Yeah, so we couldn't see it that well, man. Can you tell us about the last, like, 30 seconds of your match a little bit?
Well, I actually tripped. That's why I fell to the ground. He didn't hit me or nothing.
We saw that you. I thought, like, he got, like, a single or a double on you or something.
Nah, he didn't hit me or anything. I just tripped.
Yeah.
So I tripped back. My back was against the cage. I kind of... Oh, shit.
Michael Jackson knocking the lights out over here.
This event's been wild, man.
Yeah, man, I kind of slid down to my side. I got my guard, and man, he's pieced my ribs up. So like when he brought his arm back, I slid my knee up into his bicep. I just threw my leg over, got the triangle.
It's like an S mount kind of situation, man.
Yeah,
and you really closed it up, man. That's excellent, man. I was saying to Eric, I thought it was beautiful how much energy was in your team when the celebration for the victory, man.
Yeah.
How much time and energy, like you could kind of tell you guys were working really hard for your camp, man. Tell me a little bit about man.
Fucking 5 days a week.
How many hours a week you're training, man?
2.5-3 hours
a day,
every day.
Damn, you know, man.
5 days a week. I took time away from my kid, my family. So I wasn't going out like a fucking punk this time.
Yeah, man. It was an excellent display, man. I hope we get to see you out again, man. Before I let you go, too, I want to give you just an exclusive sticker right there.
Special edition.
Can I offer you a drink or something? You want to hang out and watch the next fight with us?
I can, yeah.
Yeah, fuck it. You want a water?
Yeah, I'll take a water, yeah.
Yeah, Brad. Brad. Crack open a Corona. DJ wants another one.
Yeah. Nah, give him a Bud Light, yo. We're running out of rodents.
All right, I heard that.
Yeah, I'm not a beer guy.
Nah, it's all good, bro. You're a violence guy. I'll take that any day of the week.
Yeah, I had a fight at, I think it was Art of War 24. Right after my fight, I was like, someone get me a fucking beer.
Yeah, for sure. Nah, man, that's great, man. Can you tell me a little bit about your gym, man? So where are you fighting at? You're not in New Jersey. The other guy was a New Jersey guy.
No, he's from Lancaster.
Oh, yeah?
My guy's out of that UFC gym in Park City. He's a good, like, I don't want to talk shit on him or nothing. He was really good. Those punches were solid.
Yeah.
I wasn't rocked or anything, but we both respected each other's hands. But nah, Moser's,
no, man. Definitely technical display. Like I was saying to Eric, man, it was a very great exchange, man. I loved to watch. It was one of the more fun fights to watch, for sure.
Yeah, no, he hit hard. I tried to hit harder.
Yeah.
But, Moser's Mat Club, man, out in Newmanstown.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very family atmosphere, as you guys could tell from the cheering and stuff.
Yeah, man, I loved it.
So,
dude,
like, you know.
You could tell there's, like, that brotherhood aspect of the team.
Yeah, man, brotherhood, we're all family out there. You know, we support each other in everything we do. And we all push each other to be the best we can be.
Yeah, man, that's beautiful, man.
Where's your gym out of? I was going to ask.
Newmanstown.
Where's that?
Newmanstown.
Okay.
Out by, you know, Myerstown.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, that's sick. Can you tell me a little bit about, like, where did you specialize in your martial arts career before you decided, like, MMA was right for you?
Honestly, I guess my start would be, like, I did, like, seventh and eighth grade like wrestling in school.
Yeah, wrestling.
And then years went by. You know, I wasn't doing anything. So I actually started going to this other gym. I started jiu-jitsu. I was being taught by a white belt. And then, you know, they had to move. They were opening a new gym. COVID hit.
Yeah.
And I remember Ben coming into our gym and showing us, like, a leg lock system, funny enough.
Yeah.
And, like, you know, ankle locks.
You fell in love with them knee bars.
Yeah. And I was like, and, like, you know, I talked to a couple people, and they all knew Ben. So I was like, all right, I'll look him up. And then, you know, me and my buddy Alex, that was supposed to fight today, he was sick. But, you know, we just went out there, the Ben's. We came on a Jits day. Just been coming ever since, like, two and a half years now.
Yeah, that's awesome, man. And then can you tell us a little bit about your, like, striking background?
Honestly, all my striking comes from Ben. Moses,
yeah?
Matt Club,
okay.
Yeah.
That's great,
all of it.
Man.
You know, I told myself when I was in the back, you know, I was, like, just, like, the basics, you know, jab, jab, cross, jab, hook, or jab, hook, cross. You know, just trying to focus on the basics. That's what I did, you know, throw a fake right and hit him with the leg.
Yeah, man, it was a really awesome display, man. Do you have any other friends that, I mean, obviously you got Moser fighting later, but do you have anyone else that you know fighting today?
Unfortunately not. My buddy Alex Estevez was supposed to fight, but he got sick yesterday.
Yeah, I saw that he was on the match list, but yeah, they didn't announce his name.
No, he got sick. He was at home with a fever, and he couldn't come out today, unfortunately.
That's sucked. It's brutal does. When it's last minute like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, he was training as much as I was. You know, he was in there because I'm his ride. You know, we carpool. I took him into every like second and hour. I was in the gym. Alex was in the gym, and he just got he couldn't come out. He was too sick.
Yeah, man, that's unfortunate. You gotta respect that shit, though, dude. You can't be going in there and not at your best.
Is he here tonight?
He's not. No.
Well, hopefully he was watching the stream at home.
I hope so.
Dude.
I hope so.
I'm sure he's stoked.
Yeah, dude.
You get the
Your whole team was so hype, man. It was beautiful to watch, like I was saying, man.
Nah, man.
That's awesome.
After that first round, man, I looked over at my kid. I started to tear up because he's sitting in the front row.
Yeah.
I started tearing up, and that's where I was, like, yelling and shit.
Yeah.
There before the match, like, began.
How old's your kid?
She's 3.
Damn, dude.
Oh, wow.
That's beautiful, bro.
Yep.
That's a great way to see daddy, man.
Yeah, man. I came out that first round. I was tired as shit, man. I looked over at her. I was like, it's fucking time to go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, that first round was excellent, though, man. It was telling Eric, man. Excellent technical display. Like I was saying to him, man, just because it's amateur doesn't mean that there's no, like, you're an expert somewhere in some component of the mixed martial arts tree. You know what I mean?
The amateurs hit just as hard as the pros do. It's just we can't use as much weapons like elbows.
Yeah.
Knees to, you know.
Heel hooks, all that.
No, we can't do any of that, but, you know, we hit just as hard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For sure, man. Got another fight here, man. Did we get the names? Did they announce who's fighting right now?
Yeah, so do you have the match list?
Yeah, I'm looking at it here. So I believe it's Tyree Thomas versus Dalton Jones.
Yeah, that sounds right.
All right.
Yeah, we got a 160-pound catchweight fight.
PA guy. Hype train boarding, man. Hopefully we get a lot of, like, fucking just brawling like we got out of Brad, man. I like seeing him stand and just throw bombs. This shit's so fucking fun to watch.
Dude, those flyweights, that first fight, I don't know if you saw, but those flyweights were cracking, man.
Yeah, man. There was so much different shit going on in your match. Lots of grappling and lots of striking, and I loved seeing that shit, man. It's beautiful.
It's nice when there's a little bit of everything.
Pull us closer to you.
It's nice when there's a little bit of everything, so you get...
Yeah, man. Dude. You need that, dude. It's MMA, baby.
Yeah,
a boxing match.
You know, a lot of people who don't do the sport, they're like, "Oh, stand up and box." You know, like men. I'm like, if you're in a street fight or in a bar or something, it's not. You're not gonna do hands only. You know.
Yeah.
Using
any
no.
tool that you can get your hands.
Yeah,
on.
Yeah, dude.
All right, here we go, man. Okay, nice pacing. Pretty bouncy.
Hey, there we go.
That's where you finished him with the triangle. Mm-hmm. Like, I have no idea what's going on. I just know Brad's hype.
That was the thing, too. I tapped him, and everybody was quiet. I was like, what the fuck? I was like, did you not see him tap?
We didn't know what happened. No. We couldn't see it from here.
Okay, we got nice cage wrestling going here.
Yeah, Thomas is really leaning on him right now.
Yeah, he's defending that. He's defending that takedown really well.
Man, that wizard can be such a bitch.
Get the dump, man.
Yeah.
Oh, come on. Yeah. Sit down, kid. Boom.
Tyree landed the takedown. Like I was telling Brad, with these short rounds, man, one takedown is all it takes to win a round.
Yeah, dude.
That's what a lot of amateur MMA is takedowns.
You missed an earlier round, man. There was a guy that got a beautiful suplex. I think that's what honestly won him the fight.
He came. The fight. My coaches and stuff are watching it back there in the room. He came back.
Yeah.
I didn't get to see it.
Yeah.
What's going on here? Looks like we got a triangle locked up.
Yeah, we got another triangle.
Dalton Jones is trying to finish this right here after getting taken down. It's still pretty early. He's got time to adjust this and finish it. That's it.
Man, what a...
Dalton Jones triangle choke finish. Oh, he did a cartwheel across the cage. That's
the
hype.
Dark Souls. He's doing the Dark Souls. Hail the sun, motherfucker.
It's really hard after you win to not showboat. And
oh, you got
it's
him,
really
bro.
Hard. My fucking mouth guard is gone.
I know.
Nah, this is fighting. It's not wrestling or jiu-jitsu. This is the fight.
Dude, someone picked that up. They're
so
selling that shit on eBay,
It just sucks. That was one of those expensive ones where you fucking mold it.
Oh,
and
you
send them all. It's about like $110.
Worth
damn.
It.
Yeah.
For a mouth guard, $110. Yeah. Do you have a $110 mouth guard for your fight?
No.
What?
Hey, maybe you'll get like submission of the night and get that money back.
Yeah.
You can only hope.
I hope so. Well, it looks like I have another triangle to compete with, so.
It was tough to see, man. It's tough to see. Who ended up winning that? Did you see?
What?
Who had the triangle? It was hard for me to see the screen.
Dalton Jones.
Dalton Jones?
Oh, shit.
Blue corner.
Okay. Oh, we got the first, like, Halloween-themed walkout song.
Yeah, what'd you think of that intermission show?
Yeah, tell us about MJ, dog.
I honestly didn't watch it, but I'm not going to lie. I like MJ a little bit, you know. But,
I'll take it. You walked out to Event Sevenfold. Yeah. That's what I was like, I like this guy right out the gate.
A little piece of heaven, yeah. It sucks they didn't play it earlier. Yeah. I like it when they get into that first part, man.
Yeah, that was good. It was a good, my favorite walkout song of the night by far.
Man,
yeah.
They didn't let me walk out to what I wanted to walk out. I wanted to walk out to Heat by 50 Cent, and they were like, no, we're not playing that.
That's okay. My first fight, they got me and my opponent's names mixed up. And
they
didn't even play my music for my first fight.
Damn, dude.
Yeah.
The silence. Yeah.
Even the promotions come a long way, I guess.
Yeah.
And I've been to quite a few MMA shows, amateur and pro. I've never seen a Michael Jackson halftime fucking intermission show.
A triangle choke by the legs.
Yeah, how about that?
How about that description of your finish?
I've never heard that. I always heard it's a triangle choke. But I mean, I guess you got the arm triangle.
I guess, yeah.
But, I mean, everybody can fucking see it. We're all watching. It's just a triangle choke.
Yeah. It's funny, man.
But, yeah, I've never heard it.
Yeah, man. It's good stuff.
We were over here laughing.
Yeah, we were, man.
Anybody who does the sports laughing.
Yeah. So do you do open mats at your spot, man? Tell us a little bit about your gym, man.
Yeah,
give them a shout-out.
Sundays, I believe... Fuck, I forget what time the open mats are, but it's every Sunday, I think, around 9 o'clock is open mats.
Every Sunday around 9 a.m.?
Yeah.
Yeah? Cool. Are you in there?
No, not for open
mats.
Not
for open mats?
No, I'm there Monday through Friday. So Mondays and Fridays are no-gi jiu-jitsu, 6 to 7:30.
Okay.
No, if we're in a fight camp, we're there even later.
At Newmantown.
Newmantown, Pennsylvania. Moser's Mat Club.
And what's the gym called again?
Moser's Mat Club.
And Ben Moser runs it.
Yep.
Nice.
Yep. Getting taught by a professional, you know. And then Tuesdays and Thursdays are striking, and Wednesdays are gi jiu-jitsu.
Oh, that's awesome. So you guys actually have a regular schedule for an MMA-oriented thing.
Yep.
That's great. Who we
we got up next? It's like Dominic Parker versus Abraham Charles, 155-pound title fight.
Yeah, we talked to both of those guys backstage.
Yeah.
For the 155-pound belt.
I think Parker fought my last match. He was a fucking beast.
Yeah, Parker?
So, yeah.
Yeah, we're going to have to keep an eye on him, man.
Yeah, definitely.
I wish on the, like, in the jiu-jitsu cards, you usually see the gym. I wish they would give us the gym name on this.
Which corner were you in? Red or blue?
Red. Red.
You're in the warm one.
Yep.
Yeah, dude, that other room's cold as hell.
That blue corner room was cold as fuck. And I think I know why, but I'm not going to say it on here. I mean, it's the first thing I noticed when I walked in.
Yeah.
Like, damn, it's freezing in here.
Yeah, dude. It was super fucking cold. Man, these guys are kind of shredded. I hope they're just throwing bombs the whole time.
Yeah.
Both of them are just jacked. You do a lot of weightlifting to prep, or like you kind of focus on just MMA, both of you, right?
Just MMA.
Yeah, man. You don't like run, nothing for the cardio?
For my very first fight that was canceled, I did a lot of running. I was running 5Ks at like twice every weekend. So Saturday, Sunday, I was running 5Ks. This past one, I didn't really run a lot, but I do weightlifting in the off season. And then once fight camp,
like,
I don't lift.
Like in the off season, like when? Like winter time or?
Well, when I'm not training for a camp.
Just your off season. Yeah. Because
when I lift, I pack on weight.
Yeah, no doubt, dude.
At the start of the camp, I was about 180 to 185.
That's your walk around weight normally, 180, 185?
Yeah, and then when I lift, it's about, I sometimes shoot up to 87 to 90.
Yeah, man, I believe it.
When I start lifting, I pack it on.
Yeah. What kind of lifting you do? Like a lot of like bodybuilder kind of shit? Like big three, powerlifting stuff?
Not much, mostly bench, you know, curls. I do look up powerlifting stuff. I try to do a lot of muscle isolation and time under tension.
Yeah.
That kind of stuff.
Yeah, that's great. Man.
A lot of abs, trunk rotation, sit-ups, crunches.
Core is so important, bro.
It is.
It's good from the hips, man. Like a lot of the, like just the striking's a lot of hips, right? But like even those leg locks, it's all, you know.
Especially trunk rotation. When you're sitting there and you're rotating your hips, is that when you go to throw those bombs, you're already used to doing that with resistance.
No doubt. Defeated. It's like Abraham Charles is actually undefeated. We're gonna see some title defense on this one.
Is Abraham out of Quintella? Is Abraham out of Quintella?
I didn't get to hear it.
Looks like they're getting hyped up over here, the Quintella boys.
Dominic Parker. And then Brad said Dominic throws bombs, so hopefully we get to see some magic happen.
My last match, he had a couple slams that were pretty solid.
Oh, nice. Yeah. You know, hopefully we get some good dynamics.
Yeah, I hope so. He's a funny guy on Facebook, too.
Yeah, that's great.
All right, here we go. 155-pound title fight. Dominic Parker out of the red corner.
Head kick.
Pacing right out the gate. Oh, yeah, this is
Advanced amateur.
Yeah, so like I was telling Brad earlier, advanced amateur is when you have three or more amateur fights. Then you'll do advanced amateur rules. Head kicks are allowed, no shin guards.
Is that it? Just head kicks? No, strikes on the head on the ground.
I don't think
still?
You can throw elbows.
No elbows? It strikes on the ground of the head still illegal?
Yeah, you can strike.
You can strike
head.
On the advanced amateur. No knees to the head, though.
Yeah. No knees?
Or elbows, I don't think.
I like it, man. They're respecting each other's space here.
Yeah.
Come on, Dom, let's go.
that's the worst thing too. Like when your opponent like is a little like hesitant, it makes you hesitate and overthink.
Yeah, man. Right. For sure.
Because you can't help but think that they're loading up on something.
Yeah.
I was talking to the guys, it's like trying to like read a wild animal, you know, you don't know what the fuck they're gonna do.
Just gotta be ready for anything, man.
Oh man, when they're hesitant and they mix it up a little bit with the feints, they really have you second guessing yourself.
For sure.
Like, are they scared or are they trying to just fake me out?
Yeah.
So Dominic whiffed a really hard lead body hook.
Ooh.
It looked like he came over the top with that right hand.
Gotta respect it for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, man, that would have been fucking greasy. Beautiful. It was like a giant, what was that, like a wheel kick?
Yeah.
You see that capoeira kick in that fucking viral video? Oh, my God, bro.
So I thought he was doing like a shift to try to change angles like Dom Cruise style. I didn't see the kick afterwards, though.
Yeah.
I mean, obviously, I'm just an amateur, but I don't know what the purpose of throwing those big, flashy, you know, cartwheel kicks and shit is. You're just blowing energy.
Yeah,
it looks cool, but you just blew the energy.
Yeah.
And you missed.
Yeah, right? Like is it worth the high risk, high reward kind of thing?
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
Yep, there we go.
kind of bounced off the wall there. Almost had some close engagement.
So it was like Dom was just short with that inside leg kick.
Yep, there's a good straight. Parker,
man, that haymaker just throwing wild shit.
Yeah, Charles whiffed those two punches, but man, he's throwing hard.
Yeah. Abraham going for that last 10 seconds, won that takedown, maybe convinced the judges he got the round on that, probably. Yep. That's a pretty wise tactic, right? Just throw a fucking big risky thing to just dominate the last portion of the match.
Those last 10 seconds, you're either unloading on the guy or you're doing a takedown.
Yeah.
Get those last points.
In your opinion, Brad, like how many strikes is equal to like a good submission attempt? It's tough to
count. Yeah, we were debating that earlier.
Yeah, it's really, it all depends on how much the guy can take, really. Yeah. Because, I mean, a couple of solid body shots right to the solar plex, like, you're pretty much done.
Yeah.
As you can see, we were both unloading on each other's heads, and we were still both good to go, you know?
Yeah.
And that's the same thing with leg kicks. You know, if you lock up that leg kick, get that lactic acid buildup, he can't move around as good, you know? Submissions, it's partial luck, partial skill.
Yeah.
You know, the luck comes in, you know, you get to the right position, the skill is being able to pull it off.
Yeah, no
doubt. With him trying
especially
to...
Especially with the gloves on. I was saying to Eric, and both of us are jiu-jitsu guys. And man, the gloves involved make it like a rear naked. It's like a different...
Yeah.
I like this, the shoulder crush one when you're wearing gloves. It's the only option,
Yeah, palm
really.
To palm, right?
Yeah.
The gable grip.
Yep.
That's why I was surprised I got the triangle, because those shinies make it a bitch and a half to get the,
yeah, the shin guards, right? Yeah. I can only imagine.
And, of course, you're practicing them without shin guards.
Yeah, right?
Yeah, but if it's fully locked because of the shin guards, it stays.
Yeah,
locked,
yeah.
And you're going to win the round if it's deep and convincing enough.
Yeah.
I heard him gurgling. I was like, fuck, I got to pull this.
Gurgling. That's awesome. Yeah. Kind of like a boxing match or kickboxing match. A lot of kicks, a lot of strikes, not too much grappling.
Yeah, of course.
Different than a lot of the other fights.
That was
of course,
hard
we can't see
because
everybody's
kick.
Standing
yeah,
up.
Yeah, for real.
Oh, spinning back fist missed for Abraham. So now they're going to find themselves clinched up.
Oh, yeah, see, wow. I told you. I fucking told you.
Dominic had a really strong underhook.
When Parker gets his hands on you, dude, when he gets his hands on you, you're going for a fucking ride.
You're going for a fucking ride, yo.
I'm telling you, if he wasn't able to get get his back away from Parker, he would have went for a solid ride.
Yeah, it was good, man. You got him down there, man. Mm-hmm. He's recovered well, though. He's a defending champion, right?
Yeah, he's undefeated. I think that makes him a little cocky with that wheel kick.
Yeah.
Parker's definitely the guy you don't want to get cocky with.
Yeah, no doubt.
His hands are down.
Great exchange, man.
They both traded left hands.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, hey, there we go.
Good, man.
There we go.
It looked like Abe clipped him with another left, though.
It's good. It's good.
Both guys try to find the rhythm. You see them exchanging their weight on their lead foot, trying to get a reaction.
A lot of nice strike connections in this round for sure, man, definitely, from both fighters.
See, Abraham's got more of a hands-down approach as Dominic has his hands a little bit higher.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Hands down can be great if you're, you know, if you're rangy.
And there we go. Solid. Oh, two solid straights.
Flipped him with a
back
left.
Back to back. And he still doesn't have his hands up. I don't.
Right. What I was saying is you see a lot of guys have the hands down style who are rangy with their 1-2s.
Because he's kind of, he wasn't like that earlier, right? He's maybe gassing out a little bit.
He looks like he's slowing down. He's not doing anything flashy. I guess he learned his lesson.
Yeah, from that big kick.
Yeah.
Ooh, damn, bro. Like a diet Superman punch or something there at the end. Jesus. Oh, it's nice. Nice exchange. Where's your confidence at on the winner on this one so far? It's pretty close.
Yeah, it's pretty close. I think it's going to go to the judge's decision. But,
no doubt.
Yeah.
I think if Parker – I think the other guy's getting gassed out, to be honest.
Yeah.
He's not –
Charles, you know, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's undefeated, so I don't think he's used to having somebody like Parker, you know, give him the works. You know, throwing those big fancy wheel kicks and having his hands out, I don't think he's used to being challenged.
Yeah. Are these advanced amateur rounds?
I think they go up to three.
Yeah,
three?
So advanced amies, three threes.
Three threes?
Now for title fights, not sure.
Yeah.
Not quite there yet, so I don't really know.
Yeah. Climbing the ladder, baby. They really respect each other's, like, space, you know?
Yep. There he goes with the fancy shit again.
Yeah,
obviously,
man.
He didn't learn.
He wants that spinning fucking back kick or something.
Yeah, he's getting really aggressive now. He's just charging forward, trying to land that overhand left. It's been working.
Mm-hmm. Abraham's smiling, man. I think he's ready for something.
Solid shit.
Oh, man, he's kind of doing some taunting a little bit here.
That was a really good shot by Abraham.
It was.
Wasn't really telegraphed. He was throwing big shots beforehand.
It was nice, yeah.
Kind of got him thinking about the power. So now they're in a dogfight position against the cage.
Who's on top, Eric?
Abraham's on top. Looks like he's landed little shots to the head.
Damn.
Wiley has that underhook, but the counterpart is he's getting wizard right now.
Yeah, Parker really needs to reverse this, man.
His hips are very close to Dominic's hips. So he's not really in danger of getting reversed right now. He's just leaning on him, putting his weight against Dom.
Oh, I see here, yeah. Got to match them hips.
Yeah, he's got Parker up against the cage.
Yeah.
Exchanging knees a little bit.
Okay, looks like Parker reversed it.
Yeah, he's going to shoot again. I can't tell if
his
hands are connected.
Parker's on top. Oh, man. Parker's punishing those ribs on Abraham. Oh man.
He took Parker down
again,
man.
Yeah, that was a big takedown by Abraham. That could be huge in the third round.
Yeah, he needed that.
Yeah.
What an exchange. Oh, I thought there was a triangle attempt or something. I mean, there's room for a triangle right here.
I can't see shit. Everybody's standing up.
for a triangle here.
Yeah.
He's doing a really good job of denying it, though. Man, that's unfortunate. That's unfortunate for Parker.
Mm-hmm. Parker's
got to really capitalize on that, man.
Yeah, he's got to do something.
All right, there's.
What's the main risk, Brad, when you're throwing a triangle up in a striking situation? Like, what are you worried about on your head getting hit?
I mean, if I was in pro level, obviously getting bombs to the head, but. Since
but in your division, right? Like, you didn't even have to worry about that. No. So the triangle's like an obvious thing to throw.
It's an obvious thing to do. So it's, you know, he's trying to throw bombs to the body, and when he brings that arm back to throw that bomb, you just slide your knee up into his
Yeah, it's helping you cut your angle, right?
Yeah. Yep.
That's awesome.
And then you just grab the arm, slip it up.
Yeah. What a great battle. Look at them. They're both bantering with each other, too. That's good, man. Tough call, man. I guess we'll see what the judges say.
It's always nice when you see the guys showing each other respect.
Yeah, man.
None of that cocky shit.
Yeah.
You know. My guy... I hope he's not hanging his head. He did a really good job. That's all I got to say, you know.
Yeah, it was an excellent fight. I think it was very close. If I was the judges, I might kind of default to going with, like, the title holder. I feel like that's, like, usually a safe bet so the crowd doesn't hit you.
Yeah.
So I think that's what we might see here.
Well, we really don't know for sure because we saw in that first fight, it was a split decision, right? 29-28 for two judges for one guy, and then a 30-27 for the other dude. That's pretty rare.
Yeah.
That one judge sees it all three rounds for one guy, and then two see it for the other. You know what I mean?
I think that happened to Aaron Kennedy back in April, I think, where he did a really good job, and then the judges decide to go with his opponent.
Yeah, it's super frustrating when you're the one that got the 30-27 but end up losing anyway.
Yeah.
See the decision here. We're really, really whacking through here. I think we have two more fights.
Yeah.
We're on the co-main event after this.
Ladies and gentlemen, how about a round of applause for these two prize fighters?
Excellent fight, man. Excellent bout.
To the judges' scorecard to make the decision. Judge one scored this bout 29-28 in favor of Parker.
Yeah, we're going to see a split.
Parker.
29-28 in favor of Charles.
29-28 Charles.
Yeah.
If it's... I really don't know now.
Winner by split decision. And the
wow.
No Six. Way. Parker got it. 29-28 on that last decision.
Yep.
Oh, no. No, Parker did not get it. He said new champion, but
yeah, I thought
he lied.
I thought that,
yeah, that's got to be brutal champion. if you're Parker, man.
Yeah, I'd be pissed.
Not a terrible decision. It was
crowd
a close
not
fight.
Happy. Crowd is not happy.
No, this is when you start to see crowd fights break out, man. I've seen it.
Yeah.
As a fighter, it just sucks, you know.
Yeah,
all the work you fucking put in, you know, to come out and get booed.
Yeah, dude. You know? For sure.
That was a tough fight, man.
It was, dude.
To get booed.
It was very close.
To get booed by the crowd, it's, you know.
Damn, man. What a great battle, though.
It was.
I loved how they were really respecting each other's space. Really capitalizing only on the open windows, you know?
Yeah.
Not too much sloppy shit.
Despite there being a title on the line, they're going for it the entire time.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
I think that first round for Abraham, the reason I think like he got that first win was that last-minute takedown, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean,
for sure.
Again, advanced amateur, it's a 3-minute round, but in the grand scheme of things, that's a short round.
Yeah, the 3 minutes ain't nothing, man.
You have to go for it the entire time, because if you take your foot off the gas, your opponent's just going to capitalize.
How long are the matches at finishers?
Like 10.
10 minutes?
Yeah.
That's awesome, man.
Crowd's not loving it right now.
Yeah, they're mad.
That's why they tell you in the last 10 seconds, you either unload or you take the guy down.
Yeah, you need to. Dump whatever you have left for that round.
Those last 10 are when it counts.
Over here. You did not see what we're doing? Oh, come on.
They're still booing over here, yeah? Come on.
All right, let's hear it for Nikki and Samantha. Thank you both.
Out of control.
All right, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm going to go spend time with my daughter and my family.
Brad, it was great meeting you, dude.
Great
meeting. Here, grab some of my stickers. If you want to grab my car, dude, if you invite me to your gym, I'd love to stop in, man.
Fucking shit.
Yep. Take care, bro.
We're going to end here tonight with our main event, the professional bout here today.
Yeah, yeah, that's my number. Thanks a lot, Brad. Take care, dude.
With that, ladies and gentlemen.
I think Eric went to the bathroom here. We're getting the co-main event overway here.
Co-main event.
You want another one? Gatorade? No problem, brother. Good stuff. Cool. All right, so we're back on track here, ladies and gentlemen. Co-main event. So we got Mike Gribos coming up here. First guy of the co-main event.
Security guard just stiff-armed me. I tried to walk out to my car, but they're making the walk out, so we can't do it. I know we're not supposed to, but I kind of
You were trying to go to your car?
No. Yeah, I'm going to slip out that door. That's pretty much our door. We got permission to pretty much...
Here.
We're gatekeeping that thing.
Yeah, we're gatekeeping. What do you need out of your car?
Protein bar.
Yeah, grab me one if you have to.
I don't. All right. Did you eat your Nature Valley?
Whatever. Yeah, I did. I ate everything. Whatever. I'll catch you. All right. The juice is loose. Getting the next fight underway here. About to see some blood, hopefully. Oh, these are the thick boys, man. Heavyweight co-main event here. Damn. They don't have the weight limit on this. They just have heavyweight title. Man, the crowd is wild right now for this one. This is going to be just straight carnage, hopefully. Real. Damn, dude. This is a title defense. So we have Mike Kennedy, the champ, versus Mike Gribos. So we have two Mikes fighting today. So this will get a little confusing. Probably gonna default to the last names here. So we have Mike Kennedy, the champ, and Michael Gribos as the contender, the challenger. We're gonna get some nice stuff overway here. Underway, overway. All the way. Man, the crowd is definitely a little excited today. My God. The juice is loose. Yeah, man. Co-main event. So we got two more fights of the night, baby. Thank you guys for tuning in. Whoever did manage to hang out with us on the live stream, I appreciate you guys supporting me. As always, giant shout out for Valley Jiu-Jitsu. Also, adarklegacy.net. Make sure you guys check it all out, baby. All in the description. Ardor 26 co-main event. Three-minute rounds of war.
Amateur heavyweight championship.
this is going to be
good.
These guys are fucking huge. 260 pounds. These are like ultra heavy, dude.
Ladies and gentlemen, with a 2-2-1 record, this is Mike Ramos.
Eric is back in the building. What's good with it, baby? Dude, what's the distinction between heavyweight and ultra heavyweight?
Ultra heavyweight is over 265 pounds.
Okay, so these are 260 then. They're right at the edge.
So this is heavyweight, right?
These boys are thick as fuck.
Thick boy nation.
Oh yeah, we got a chance to talk to We got a chance to talk to Mike a little bit beforehand.
That's good shit, man.
And now for your pre-fight instructions, your referee, David O'Sullivan.
Man, heavyweight fights usually go one of two ways.
And what are those two ways?
Center of the cage slugging it out, or someone gets a takedown, and that's just the way it goes.
I hope we get our first knockout of the night, because that's another way that heavyweights sometimes go, kind of to tie in with your first way here.
Yeah, we've seen some good grappling. We had a couple triangle choke finishes and a rear naked.
Yep.
But no TKOs or KOs yet.
They're saying, let's go, Mike. They don't understand that they're both named Mike.
You know, I don't wish harm on anybody. But I kind of hope somebody gets a knockout just for the sake of our entertainment.
Oh, damn. The champ just shook Mike Gribos here.
Yeah. I might have to stand up for this one.
Fucking bombs, dude.
Oh!
Let's go. TKO. Oh. TKO.
That needs to be stopped.
What the fuck?
That was the latest stoppage I've ever seen in my life. Maybe not in my life, but.
That ref was a little late on that call. What do you think, Eric?
Yeah, that was horrible. They rung the bell, and the fight wasn't over. They rung the bell, and the fight wasn't stopped. That's how bad the stoppage was.
He punched him like three more times after we heard the bell. The ref was a little late on that.
I'm not trying to bash the ref, but that's the one that told me I couldn't do 50-50.
Rough.
Yeah, that was rough. You know, it gets to the point where it's like, Are you looking out for the fighter's safety or not?
Honestly, dude.
When the person rings the bell before the referee stops it, that's how you know it's bad.
That is pretty rough. Sorry about that, guys. Looks like I had a connection drop on the stream there. We're back online, though. Yo, Kevin CeeLo in the house. What's up, baby? I love you, man.
Yeah, looks like Mike Gribos is going to be all right. He's back to his feet now.
That's good.
The champ.
You gotta fucking love it, man.
Mike Kennedy's going to keep his title. The sick knockout. We were calling it, too. We were hoping for a knockout.
Excellent display, man. Just, dude, these heavyweights, like, people don't understand, man. The brain of you is the same brain they have, bro.
Yeah.
You're just getting hit with fucking car crashes after car crashes.
Woo. Yeah, it's really, like...
So much damage, dude.
And, you know, it's not Mike's fault. I mean, your brain shuts off. What can you do about that? You know
dude,
what I mean?
Can't. The ref's supposed to be the one to do something about it. Fuck. Brutal. Oh, he's a Martinez BJJ guy too, of course.
Yeah, you can see Will and Matt in the corner over there.
Mr. Turnbull over here supporting.
My cousin just had a
post my the link in my bio to GoFundMe.
That's amazing, dude.
On my page at Wild Mike MMA. If anybody would like to support me, the link is right there for GoFundMe. I appreciate it.
All right, guys. So Wild Mike MMA. Everyone, check it out. Anyone that's watching this, looks like the one shout out he gave was for a family member of his just had a house fire. So if you want to contribute to the GoFundMe, you got to go check the man's handle out and take care of business with that. That's awesome, man. Got to use that platform for responsible things. That was awesome to see that. Man, what a battle too. That was quick.
Yeah, man, 42 second knockout. As clean as it can get too. It looks like Gribos was out on his feet a little bit before he dropped.
Yeah, dude.
I figured I'd say it now to get out of the way. So far, middle of the third for the World Series game, the Astros are leading 3-0.
Oh, why would they even say that?
For real, why would you say that?
It's early. Could be way worse. I come from Pittsburgh,
that's awesome.
And we have the Pirates. So, hey, what's that tell you?
That's awesome, man. Hype train boarding.
Oh, man, his team's going wild over there.
I want to remind all of you that Art of War is going to be out in Newtown, Pennsylvania. Art of War 27 is going to take place on Saturday night, December the 10th. It's going to be an unbelievable night featuring Matt Turnbull, Christian Moby, Cody Russell, Johnny Gardner.
Eric Naples.
Not yet.
It's going to be a great
somebody event. Take a fight with Eric.
But it's going to take place in Newtown, PA on Saturday night, December the 10th for Art of
Oh, nasty. I think I just drank Brad Eisenhower's water.
Nah, he took his.
Oh, really?
His. Yeah, he took his. I offered him a second one. He just took his.
Good dude, man. I enjoy talking to him.
It was nice that he took a seat with us.
We're
going
to need a lot of that here for the final night. I see a lot of t-shirts out there, so you guys have been sitting kind of quiet. That's all right. But we are hoping that we have a raucous final fight here tonight with that. Where is the big man? I don't know where he is, but are you guys ready for our final fight of the night?
Final fight.
That's good enough for me. Here we go.
Terry from Final Fight.
Yeah. There's nothing like local MMA promotion, like ring announcers, man. They just have a different energy.
Yeah.
Got the challenger walking out. Oh, this is not a title fight.
No, we got Federico Vento making his walk to the cage right now. He'll be taking on Ben Moser, teammate of Brad Eisenhower, who was just taking a seat with us a minute ago.
Yeah, Ben.
Congrats, big man.
Yo, you want to hang out? You want a beer?
Yeah, what's up?
All right, we might get Mike Kennedy sitting down with us in a couple minutes.
Yo, Mike.
We'll let him make his way, say hi to some family and teammates.
You want to have a seat quick? You want a water? You want a Gatorade?
Water.
We got you. Here, I'll get it. Okay.
I lost my voice. I don't know when I lost
yo,
my voice.
Yo, it's all good, bro. Yo, yeah, that's awesome.
Talk loud into this thing.
Yeah, man. Yo, Mike, tell us about it, man. You shook him quick and then knocked him over, man. You really identified the instability in his stance and kind of capitalized on that knockout. You're beautiful.
Yeah, definitely. A lot of watching his fights was just a lot of patterns that he throw, and the fact that I didn't really feel as though he had me beat in the speed category. I knew I had him beat there, and I knew that if I could catch him on the end of his punches or before he could throw, countering him, then I could land clean. And I knew if I land clean, then he goes to sleep.
Yeah, man, I was just saying to Eric, man, like, we all got the same brain no matter what the size, and you're just hitting him with car crash after car crash.
Absolutely.
And you're heavyweight, man.
Absolutely. After the first Lee Hook, Jay Cross, I felt it. I saw his body. He didn't like it at all. And I knew that if I could land again, I rushed it, and I know I did, and he hit me. And I knew that if I took my time, if I can throw it again clean, and I land clean, that he goes out. And I waited, I played my cards right, I let him throw his little shots, which I said he didn't have a lot of speed to them, nor power. I waited, I let him throw, and I caught him at the end of it, and he went to sleep.
Yeah, that was awesome, Mike, man.
Yes, and correct me if I'm wrong.
Let me slide through this really quick before you go.
Yeah, a little holographic sticker.
Appreciate it. I appreciate it so much.
It was a
Can I take a look at the belt?
Absolutely.
Hell yeah, man. Let's have a look at that thing.
On camera.
Yeah.
So it was a right hook that had him out on his feet, fell forward, and then we finished it off. You know what we were saying? It was crazy. The bell rang before the ref actually stopped it, which is weird.
I heard the bell ring, but we talk about it in the back, and I knew that the fight wasn't over. I knew Sumi had a time on the clock, so I don't know why the bell rang, but I do understand that it's a fight, and the ref stops the fight.
Yeah, you got to keep throwing the bombs, right?
Yeah, if I chose to stop because of the bell, he got back up and knocked me out, then that's just the fight game.
Yeah, that's exactly what we were saying, too. You know, we thought it was a little bit of a late stoppage, but none of the fault is on the fighters or the corner or anything, you know. But for the bell to ring before the ref stops it, that's a little strange. I've never seen that.
Yeah, to be honest, I thought it was a little late also. The way that his body rocked and he fell.
Oh, for sure.
I thought that the ref was going to stop it right there, but when he didn't, I followed up. I thought after the first strike, he was going to stop it, but he let me go on until he eventually did. I thought that it could have been stopped as soon as he fell.
Yeah, man.
Well, dude, it doesn't get any cleaner than a 42-second knockout to defend your
title. Absolutely.
Yeah. Yo, tell me a little bit about the gym, man. You got Martinez BJJ, right?
That's absolutely. So I've been at Martinez now for just over a year, and we have amazing guys over there. Pat Brady, Kyle Dawkins, Chris Dawkins, the brothers. We got Matt Turnbull. We have so many people over there. Even the guys that just started. Y'all saw my teammate fight first, Malik. We have George, Brandon. We have an amazing team over there.
Yeah,
and
man.
We all work. We all try to get each other better. We got other big guys, Ryan and Kale. I love those guys over there. We work so hard together. We push each other. And we push each other so much in the gym that fight time, it's easy.
Hell yeah, man. When do you guys have an open mat, man? I just started working in Philly. I want to drop by one of these days, man.
Pull up Sunday afternoon. Pull
I'm
up
good, I got
Sunday
it.
Afternoon.
Come.
Sunday afternoon for the open mat.
Yeah, Will just called your ass out, man.
I know, he's called me out. I'll come this week, yo. I'll come this week. I promise.
Come this week.
I'll
come this week.
Come, dude. What day? What day are you gonna be in? I'll come.
I'll be back in. Not this Sunday. Pull up next Sunday. Open mat. Next Sunday. Open mat at noon. At noon.
Yeah. Word.
All right. If he doesn't show up, you gotta go body shot for body shot.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You can challenge me for the belt next.
For sure. I'll have to give you my number before.
Absolutely.
I'll make sure I'm in there.
I'll swing back around for that.
Fuck yeah.
I appreciate you guys.
Sick, man. Well, congratulations. Enjoy the rest of your night.
Yeah, man. You want a Gatorade for the road?
Please.
Yeah. What color? We got all of them.
Surprise me.
Yeah.
Don't give him red. Red sucks.
Yellow's good.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
You're the man, Mike.
Thank you. Y'all
enjoy. Let me give you my number really quick. Or let me get yours or something.
Yeah.
Yo, you got his Instagram.
Take down my Instagram and you can DM me. Oh, never mind. Here it is.
Yeah.
Introducing to you first, competitor number one.
Here you go.
In the blue corner, he stands to my right. He weighed in at 132 pounds. He represents AP Boxing.
All right, that was Mike Kennedy, your Art of War heavyweight champion.
Good shit, man. That was awesome of him. Yeah, take it easy, man. Man, what a fucking great set of matches tonight. Yeah, come on, hang out. Dude, come hang out.
Speak
come
your peace, man.
Dude, it was a fucking such a close match, man. Fucking Brad over there too. We were hanging out with Brad Parker. Yo, and he was saying the last fight that he had, you were on the card and you're slamming.
Yeah, Brad Eisenhower was. He was here. So yeah, I want you to talk us through that. What were you thinking at the end of the fight? And then when you heard that it was going to be a split, were you worried at all? What were you thinking?
Can they hear everything fine?
What's up?
Can they hear everything fine with all the
yeah, just talking to that.
It's all on YouTube. Okay. This is on YouTube.
Well, after I was very confident going into the decision. Even when they said split decision, I was still fairly confident because other than a couple body kicks and that takedown at the end, I didn't feel like he did too much to win the fight. Even when he got the takedown, I had submission threats, so I don't really know I don't know. I defended takedown for a solid minute.
It was such a technical exchange, man. It honestly, like, I think one of the reasons maybe they went the way they did is because, like, you got to kind of favor the defending champion a little bit when you're making your decision.
This was a vacant belt.
Yeah, it was a vacant belt.
Wow.
Yeah.
I didn't even know that.
Yeah.
What I was thinking going into the decision, because there was a little bit of a wacky decision in the first fight with the flyweights, man.
I heard about that.
I was just telling Mike. So two judges had 29-28 for one guy, and the other one was 30-27 for the other. That's weird, right? Yeah.
That's a big discrepancy,
man. It was so tight.
The gap between everyone was so tight.
I don't know. I had him bleeding from his face. I thought the damage and the striking would be significant enough to... Yeah.
Well, we know you won the second round because that's the one where you hit that big takedown.
Yeah. It was
slam.
Excellent.
Yeah.
It was excellent. Loud as fuck. So, could hear that across the street. I'll pass you that. Let's watch this match. You want to help commentate us on this one?
I'll do what I can from what I can see.
Yeah, we got Ben Moser over here.
All right, Ben Moser cleaning it up. Ben's on the bottom here. We got a half guard kind of a thing going on right now. Okay. A little bit of a stagnant exchange for the moment. We're on the cage.
Yeah, so who's on top? Looks like Vento's on top right now. We got a full guard. He's not closing it up. He's grabbing his own ankle. Looks like he's trying to create an angle for something. And this is pro, so.
Everything goes.
Yeah, I think this is our only pro fight of the night.
This is the last fight, isn't it?
Yeah, it's main event.
Yeah.
I think yours, So yours and the heavyweight title fight were the only amateur advanced rules for tonight.
Who won the last one?
What's that?
Who won the last one? They're both Mikes.
Yeah, Mike Kennedy did.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, he knocked Mike Gribos out in 42 seconds.
Oh, he got the KO. Thought Moser would control the grappling exchanges.
Yeah. Yes, they say Brad was telling us Moser's pretty strong in the grappling scene. So, what would you say, Dominic? Is your where's your strength lie in your grappling or your striking? You definitely look very confident on the feet.
Yeah, I was initially a wrestler, but I like striking more, way more. So, yeah, as you can tell, yeah.
Yeah. Dom, can I offer you a beverage? We got beers, water.
Hell yeah. Yeah.
What do you want?
What you want?
Everything. One of each.
Yeah, I thought you looked familiar. You had the crazy hair last time, didn't you?
What's that?
You had crazy hair last time?
It was pink at the Art of War. Yeah, I fought the dude Brandon from Martinez.
Hands, yeah, he's sharp with hands.
God, I want it, man. God, I think everyone did, to be honest. I'm on podcast.
Oh, he got a Corona. All right.
Yeah, he's good.
Well, I'm going to crack open a Bud.
Yeah, Budski. I heard I got suspended.
For what?
90 for
walking
kicking
out?
The trash can, yeah.
What'd
walking
you do?
Up. Walked out, kicked the trash can.
That's Pennsylvania, man. Pennsylvania, the commission doesn't.
Kicking a trash can?
$100 fine and suspended.
Wow.
The commission doesn't fuck around.
Oh, dude, we got dumped. Dude, Ben just got a nice dump. Excellent, excellent.
Yeah.
We got Ben Moser on top now.
One and two had it. I swear. No way, right? What do I got to do? I guess more volume, right?
Damn, dude.
Not much happened.
No.
I guess that last takedown.
I think we got Ben on the top.
And I didn't almost triangle him, right?
Front headlock position.
Yep, it's nice.
I was trying my thighs.
Oh, man, dude, that is weird. God, dude, it's such a terrible angle for me to see.
Yeah, one
a lot of dynamics. Out. Damn, Ben just dropping bombs.
Unloaded,
Ben's
dude.
Dropping bombs on the man.
Ben Moser just landed two really hard left hands.
Oh, dude, I think we might get a rear naked choke finish here.
Yeah, he's punching on him, too. Opening him up.
Damn.
He's got it sunk in.
Oh,
now he got out.
Spun out. What an excellent exchange on the ground.
Yeah. No.
Wow. Oh, dude. Oh, man. Yo, can we kick from the ground? Can we do head kicks from the ground?
Yes. Yeah, you can up kick to the face.
What do you have to do to
win? Oh, man, we got blood.
Yeah, that was probably from those two lefts that Ben landed on the ground a couple seconds ago.
trying to decide, right?
I asked him. Oh,
going for a single there.
Oh, a knee just barely misses by
like
Ben.
Federico's left eye, man. We got some blood on Federico's left eye.
Me and my friends are rambling on the podcast.
Yeah,
and
no, it's all good, man. They're not coming up on the mic. It's good. Yeah. Yeah, you can chill.
You good? You good, bro?
Yeah, I'm gonna come over there after this.
Nice, man. Back on the feet. Ben's looking nice and good, man. Federico's a little shook. It looks like to me. I don't know, man. It's close. It's looking kind of close right here.
So, bro, what gym are you out of?
Team Vicious, Williamsport.
Team Vicious out of Williamsport.
Williamsport School of Self-Defense, but the MMA team is
okay.
Team Vicious.
Nice,
we do
nice.
Boxing and whatever. So. I thought I was banging him up, right?
It was good, man.
Piecing him up.
It was an excellent fight,
yeah.
though, man.
Yeah, you landed some bombs in the first.
It was fucking close.
You landed some good shots in the first, man.
I think he hit me like twice.
It was a tough decision for the rest. It was split. You know what I mean? What he went by 1 point. You know what I mean?
One takedown, I guess.
It's tough.
It's just crazy because before I told myself, I was like, the only way I won't be upset by losing is if it's a close decision.
Right.
I think that made it way worse.
No, it fucking definitely makes it way worse, bro. Yeah. I'd rather get 30-26 knowing I lost.
Knowing
you
lost, right? Yeah. Except for when you're sitting there like, I won, right? I won. And then,
no, you didn't. That's awesome, man.
Sundays are open mat, so we have a good day.
Two.
Okay.
All right, we're back up here. Okay. Oh, no! Dude, Federico just got...
What happened?
Federico, yo, it looked like a knockout punch.
Oh!
That was rough. Okay, man, way to go.
Federico Vento gets the KO. Yeah,
did not see that coming, guys.
Around.
Coming at you live from...
Ben is not okay. He's still down.
Wow.
What's this podcast called?
Grab the sticker, bro. Grab a bunch
of
them.
I got two of them.
Yeah,
I got them.
Yeah. Man, that was excellent, man. So Federico looks like he had a nice hook coming in, and Ben's chin was ripe for it, dude.
Shut up, old lady. Thank you guys for having me up here. Yeah.
Thanks a lot.
Enjoy your night,
bro. Stay in touch, man. Find me on Instagram. Let's get in touch. I'll come visit, man. Let's train. Yeah. Go. Take a couple. Thanks, guys.
Have a good night.
Yeah, peace. Man, dude, what a fucking ending. God, that was the knockout of the night.
Unexpected, dude.
Really unexpected. I feel like Ben was dominating that last round, and Federico really really found a window.
Yeah,
and
you know.
Just closed it with that hook, man. That was a beautiful hook.
And you notice how quiet it is in here. Ben was, I don't want to say the favorite, but he was kind of like, you know, he had a lot of people in here rooting for him tonight.
Yeah.
And in these local events, that's a huge advantage.
Oh, for sure, dude. Imagine the mental toll that takes if no, like, you know what I mean? Not that many people are cheering.
So Ben's okay. How you doing, champ?
Hang out, man. Can I offer you a beverage?
You got some water?
Yeah, water coming right up.
This one's brand new. Nobody touched it.
Yeah,
thank you, man.
You can take one of those, too. Yo, we're doing great man. Let's talk a little bit about your match, baby.
Split decision win, right?
Split decision. It was a little, it was tougher. Probably my toughest fight I've been in.
Let me bring this a little closer to you.
Yeah, I'm awful. Probably the toughest fight I've been in, but, you know, we got it done.
Yeah, we were just speaking to Don Parker a minute ago. We were talking about the decision, maybe the reasons why he thought he won versus why the judges would have gave it to you. You know, like we were saying, very close fight.
It was such a great, like the judge decision was very close.
Yeah.
I think both of you performed incredibly well, man.
Yeah, you guys looked great.
It was a great like match of the skills.
Yeah,
you know?
It was really tough because coming in, I knew he was a really good striker. Uh-huh. And he showed that because he kept his distance away because, you know, in my previous fights, I won a lot of the ground battles, so kept good distance. You know, he got me a little impatient. Especially in the second round, which is he definitely won the second round because he landed most of his hits.
Yeah, I was gonna say that's what it looked like in that round for sure.
So I
think you had a really wise strategy in that first round. You really you fished for that takedown immediately.
For sure.
I think that really secured the win for that first round.
Those takedowns definitely secured a win for me because coming into the third, like my coach just said, it's all or nothing. Because if I would have had another second round, I definitely would have lost that fight. So coming in, I knew I had to stop throwing hooks and throw more straights to get him onto the cage because watching film, that's something he's not really good at defending takedowns on the cage. So once we threw some straights, got him on the cage. You go for a double leg, and I was able to hold him down for the rest of the fight.
Yeah, it's interesting. We were talking about your style a little bit. You have more of a hands down approach, and you were throwing big hooks at him, like you were just mentioning. And I think that actually may have helped you because you were throwing those big hooks. Maybe he wasn't expecting you to shoot so often. He was expecting your bombs to keep on coming.
Yeah, the moves were not telegraphed, right? Your takedown attempts. It was nice. They're very sporadic.
That's exactly right, because I don't like the fight with the hooks. That's something I'm working on, because that's in the back. I'm throwing straights. It's just you get frustrated because he was moving real good. So
both
you know,
of you were moving so well.
Yeah, he was moving so well.
I thought you were gassing out a little bit.
Oh, no, I don't gas out.
Yeah, that's why I thought the hands were coming down. I thought you were gassing, but obviously like you kind of like picked it back up.
When the hands drop, I get more comfortable. The energy flows better. It's just not. It's just not what you should do, but you know,
of course.
People that maybe don't train, they don't understand. When you're in there, you're gonna be doing stuff completely different than what you're training. You're gonna be doing what you feel like you should be doing in that moment.
Yeah, you gotta get to a comfort level in the cage, and that's what I had to find in the third.
Yeah, man. Well, you did an excellent job, bro.
I appreciate you guys.
Oh, yeah, man.
All right, thank you, man.
So tell us a little bit about your gym, man. When do you guys train? Do you have an open mat? People can come train with you guys?
I train at Quintella MMA and Jiujitsu.
Where's that at?
That's in Ridley, PA.
Okay.
Yeah. It's towards the city more. Our sensei, I believe he's a 6-degree black belt Brazilian jiu-jitsu, so it really ain't many places you can go to get better jiu-jitsu.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So
where do you go to kind of get your striking sharp? Because it's obviously very sharp.
I do everything there. He Muay Thai certified, everything.
Oh, you do both at the same spot?
Oh, yeah, I'm at the same gym, man. That's where I started, and that's where I'm at now. You know, it's working out for no. I don't feel like any changes need to be made. I do have training partners who are pros that I work with. You know, I work with Sandy, with one of the ladies that was in my corner. She's a pro fighter. She holds pads for me. You know, she teaches me stuff. And that's just what it is. That's where my gym is. I don't feel like I need to change anything. I just need to work on things better, because I know my striking isn't matched with my grappling yet, because I've been grappling for so long in my life.
Really?
But I'm climbing up. This is only year three of me striking. So, you know.
Man, you look sharp to me, man.
I'm trying to figure it out. Thank you, man.
You mentioned Sandy Bang Bang Chang, right?
Yes, sir.
Does she have any fights coming up?
Yes, sir. November 18th, Sherman Theater, I believe. I don't know how far it is from here, but I don't think it's too far. She'll be fighting for Maverick. So, you know, people should definitely
come. Yeah, we've known about her
fight
for a while. She's been in the game for a long time.
Oh, dude, she's a savage, man.
Yeah.
she punches you straight in the face every time.
Yeah.
Right in the teeth. So, you know, I get used to getting hit.
There's the man right there, Ernest Cronin. We know him.
Ernest Cronin. That's the guy in my corner, man. I appreciate you guys. This guy showed me so many cool shit that I just don't get to use.
Yeah, I know, yo.
I'm going to use him one day. I'm going to make him proud, though.
How much of your grappling can't you use here, right? Like, can't do any of the leg locks and stuff like that?
It's pretty tough, dude, because once you get punched in the face, dude, it's so hard to think about fucking jiu-jitsu.
The matter, right?
Yeah.
Not me. I get hit. I want to do jiu-jitsu.
Dude, I'm telling you, bro. Yeah. You put a dude down, especially this is my first event. Amateur, so I really wanted to, you know, finally
your first advanced amateur.
Yeah, I could finally land some head blows.
Oh, this was your first advanced amateur?
Yeah,
dude, that's excellent, man.
Dude, so I really wanted to land some head blows, and I feel like, thank you, man. I feel like once I got him down, he did kind of close guard, so it's like I might as well land some hits. I could have passed, but I didn't want to lose control, because the first thing
that's smart,
my sensei teaches is control. If you don't have control, you don't
earlier in the rounds, you saw the scramble and you guys ended up back on the
feet. That's what I'm saying.
So it was smart that you kind of decided that.
Yep. Even when he flipped me, boom, just get right up. That's the first thing that came in my head.
It worked out for you, obviously,
yes,
man. It was excellent.
Thank
that was
you,
such a fun fight, man.
It was fun to be in. That was the toughest fight I've been in.
We were having a hard time deciding who won before the refs, or the judges' decision came. I'm like, man, I don't even fucking know, dude. It was a good fucking fight. That's all I know.
That's definitely true. My corner felt like I had it secured after the third, because I felt like the first was pretty even. I don't know who you would give it to, but I feel like he definitely took the second. I definitely took the third. So it was a good fight overall. I hope he keeps his head up, because me and him had a talk. You know, he's angry about it, but you know, I understand how he feels.
It was a close match.
Yeah, it was a close fight. So
yeah, absolutely. We were just talking to him a minute ago, and he had nothing but good things to say. So
yeah,
he's definitely gonna keep his head up, and we're gonna see him back.
Yeah, he's gonna go places, man. he's going to go places in this sport. We just got to keep our head up. Like, at the end of the day, somebody has to win, somebody has to lose.
It's a two-man sport. That's how it goes.
Yep. Yes, sir.
Yeah, we're going to let you go with your team. They're all waiting here so you get to celebrate your win. Oh, yeah, enjoy man. The rest of your night, man, and congratulations on the championship.
Thank you, guys.
Really
thank you, man. You, bro. Appreciate you guys.
Grab a bunch of stickers if you want. Find me on Instagram. I'd love to link up, man. Maybe we can train.
Is this the Instagram?
Yeah, you can look that up. Find a hashtag.
I got you, man. We're pretty far, man. You're going to drive 2 hours.
Yeah, whatever, man. I'll make it happen. Keep me posted. Help yourself. Grab some.
You guys want a sticker?
Cool. All right, man. Well, Erica, looks like we're coming to a close here with the night. What are your final thoughts? I think Art of War 26, we got to see some incredible knockouts. The last two rounds ended with some striking bout stuff. Great submissions, right? We got to see some triangles, some rear naked
chokes.
Yeah,
we got three submissions, two knockouts, and both knockouts were in the last two fights. You know, really good night of finishes. I've been to a lot of MMA events. Some of them can be kind of boring, but this one was not one of those, man. This was fireworks. And we got that dope little halftime show by MJ himself, dude.
Brought back to life.
Yeah, like I was saying, if you didn't check that out, it's on my story. That was a riot,
yeah,
man.
Make sure you guys check out Eric Naples, Naples Syrup on Instagram. And yeah, man, make sure you guys follow Art of War. They have incredible stuff coming up, man. They're really supporting the MMA community here. I'm loving that I'm seeing so much of these, like the jiu-jitsu community is a very strong presence in Pennsylvania
MMA.
Yeah,
for sure.
And it's beautiful to see that.
It's not quite intertwined yet, but...
Yeah, it's very close.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Also, big, huge shout-out to Mike and Deb for allowing us to be here tonight and call these fights and have our podcast rolling.
Yeah, man, this was like a fight companion kind of thing. If you guys want to see more of this, I personally love hanging out with Eric.
Yeah,
I think I'm gonna try to do more of this. If you guys liked it, let me know in the comments, and make sure you subscribe and everything. What's that?
Yeah, you wanna jump in?
Yeah, man, come hang out. Nah.
Come on, dog. We just talked to your boy.
Yeah, man. Yeah, come on. Oh, we got some fans and stuff over here.
Let him get a picture with the fans first.
Absolutely. It was such a good night, man. Well, oh my God, man, that knockout on Ben was rough.
On the heavyweights, right? Dude,
no, the last match here, Ben caught like a hook.
Yeah,
put
yeah.
Him, put him
oh
right down,
yeah,
him right
I got,
down.
I'd have to see a replay of that.
Yeah, I hope we can get to see that, man.
All right, we got Malik Danz, is that right?
Yeah,
just
man.
Made your pro debut. Your amateur debut,
dude. And quite a debut, man.
Yeah.
It was an excellent fight, man. Right out the gate with the fireworks, man. I got to say, it was right out the gate. I knew we were in for some heat.
I don't
tonight.
Remember anything.
You don't remember
no,
anything?
I don't.
Man, I'll tell you what. My first fight, it was against your boy Brandon Bohannon,
really?
Man.
Oh,
yeah,
really?
I fought Brandon. I only remember bits and pieces of that fight.
Yeah.
That first one, it's so rough, and that's what everybody was telling me.
For sure,
so.
For sure.
You know, I can imagine what you're feeling, but I'll tell you what, you went out there, you performed really well, man.
Yeah, man. It was a close fight, right? It went to ref decision. Obviously, like the second ref, or the second judge, rather, had you favored by multiple points.
30-27.
Yeah, you 30-27,
yeah.
Again, I can't comment on it until I watch the fight.
You got
to
watch the fight,
again,
of course, yeah.
Yeah.
It's a blur for you, right?
Yeah, exactly.
How old are you, man? You look young as
I'm
hell.
18.
What?
Get this away from me.
I was about to offer him a beer, yo.
Starting early.
You want a Gatorade or a water or anything?
I'm all right.
You're good?
Right.
You're good?
Yeah,
all
I'm
right,
good.
Man. All right.
Thank you.
Hell yeah, sick, man. Yo, well, here, let me, before you get out of here.
Hey, when are we going to see you back?
We'll see. Like, maybe like February. We'll see.
February?
All right. Yeah.
All right, man.
I gotta polish some stuff up, you know?
Yeah,
no,
man.
Absolutely.
That's
all
that's
it
the
is,
mission,
man.
Baby.
Just
that's
getting
the
those
game.
Reps in.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, man.
Well, sick. Here he is, making his amateur debut, Malik Danz.
Yeah.
He had a banger of a first fight to open up the card tonight. We hope to see him back on more of these cards. Hopefully, we're here doing these podcasts on those cards as well.
I will be back.
Yeah, it was awesome, man. Malik,
thank you.
Great to talk to you, brother.
Thank you.
Take care.
Thank you.
Man, I just kind of realized I only put the overlay up one time.
It happens, man. It's whatever.
Oops.
18 years old, making his amateur debut. That's crazy young, man.
Dude, I know.
I know.
He said 18. I thought he said 19. Oh, my God. That is so young. So young, man. What a game, man. Like, what was your favorite fight of the night? Let's close on those sentiments here.
Well, hey, Brad's triangle was pretty sick. But, man, you can't get wrong with a fast knockout. And I'm only going to say the Mike Kennedy fight because I had such a clear view of it.
Yeah,
I saw the punch connect right to the jaw.
out on his feet, face plans. We saw the finish.
Yep.
Now, I'd have to, like I was saying earlier, I'd have to see that that finish in the main event again to really know what happened. It didn't look like anything really significant landed. But again, it's kind of tough when you're cage side and you got the doors and the posts in the way and stuff.
Yeah.
You got people standing up. So.
And this is our first time doing this as well. So, like, obviously for the next one, we're going to make sure we have better real estate.
Oh, yeah.
We want to make sure we can cover the game better for you guys.
Well, hey, this is the spot we're in now is definitely a hell of a lot better than where we originally were going to set up.
Hell, yeah. Yeah, yeah. In retrospect, we definitely made a good call by moving over here.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you guys for tuning in. Man, my voice is super hoarse. I'm excited, man. I'm excited to see your next fight, man. We're gonna chat with Mike later, and hopefully we can get Eric another fight. So I want to see my man work it.
Maybe this spring, late this spring.
Yeah, man. So let me ask you this: if someone's interested, and it's probably different for everybody. If someone's interested in getting into MMA, how can they approach Art of War? Like, how did you get into this promotion?
Well, it's a funny story. I didn't talk to promoters at all. I talked to Ruben, the gym owner of the Hive, the gym that I teach at.
Yeah.
I just said in passing one day, I said, hey, I think I want to fight. I wasn't training striking or nothing like that.
Yeah, at the time.
And he was like, you want to fight? All right, I'll talk to this promoter, this guy, we're going to get you a fight. Get your medicals done. And I'm like, well, hold on, slow down. I said I might want to fight. And then a week later, we had an opponent. It was originally going to be at a promotion called Dead Serious. That guy ended up pulling out.
Yeah.
And then we were looking. We had a little bit of trouble finding me a match. And then just like I was talking to Malik, I did take that match against Brandon Bohan, an extremely talented young dude from Martinez BJJ.
Yeah. They're studs over there, man.
But basically, if you want to get into MMA, just find a gym that's supportive, that has active fighters, and, you know, let your coaches and your more experienced teammates handle it from there. They will guide you in the right direction.
Dude,
because I didn't know what the hell to do.
Dude, that's powerful to have resources like that can get it done for you. So that, I think, it's incredible how, like, the human resource of networking is such a good tool in every field, man.
It is.
Especially fighting, music, everything.
Because just imagine if none of the guys had teams like they do, you know, it takes a tribe to really build a fighter.
I think that's a great sentiment to end this on, man. It takes a tribe.
Yeah.
Well, thank you guys very much. Make sure you follow Eric again. Subscribe if you like the show, and we'll be back at it again hopefully soon. I love you all. Peace.
All right. Peace.